couldn't get on the ride? What's the matter? They afraid you go pee-pee in your diapers?
Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another episode of the Cinema Scumbags Movie Podcast. My name's Seth.
I'm Nick D.
I'm Matt.
I'm Filmy's Nick.
This is episode number 64 of the show. Let's just say special thanks again to Patrick Bryce for coming on last week.
That was awesome.
Thanks, Patty. Thanks, Matt.
Yeah, I think that was, heard from a couple guys that really like listening to that. So that was great. Good time.
Super cool guy.
Yeah.
If you guys still haven't seen Creep, check that fucking movie out. Solid as fuck.
Yep.
Yeah. Pretty cool to have him on the show. So what's new? What's going on?
Well, life. Seth.
Life.
Life's getting in the way. No more drama.
No more. You painted?
No, I'm gonna be getting painted Labor Day weekend.
Great.
New carpet.
Oh.
If you guys watch the Scumbags YouTube channel, I do the videos every once in a while with the green walls. I'm that guy.
Yeah. There you go.
You can match the voice of the face.
What color
now.
Are we going with? Yeah, what color are we going with?
No more drama. You can look it up. It's a red color.
Oh,
a red.
Is that what it's called?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Dad, I want a red room.
I select my paints and style.
You can't just do like a white room like a normal person. Fucking
no,
red.
I want red. Give me red.
Yeah, put me in a white box. Fucking THX 1138. No thanks.
So did you get like the red to match your beanie that you always wear?
There you go, bud.
So that's what it is. Huh?
I have two of those red beanies, but I need to purchase a new one.
A little pinkish.
Well, you can, fuck yourself.
I wasn't making fun of you there, bud. I was just pointing out the obvious.
It's 95 degrees, sir. Could you take the beanie off?
Hey, I haven't been caught dead wearing a beanie outside in quite a while. Only indoors.
Hey, well, you know what?
And when you swim.
When we, we're in California in November. Are you going to be wearing a beanie?
November.
Nick, are you wearing a beanie to California?
Do you think it'll be all right if I do?
I think so. I think you're going to need one.
It'll be my
turn. It's still going to be like 95 degrees over here.
Middle of the night when we're, shooting our top secret project?
Damn, I won't get to bring my director's jacket.
Oh, you can bring it.
Darn.
No, actually, it might be cold out there.
A little chilly out there.
Ooh, I'm going to need it.
A little chilly. Fuck yeah.
Good stuff. No, other than that, Seth, I wanted to bring this up, dude. Rewatched Big.
Oh.
I was wanting to ask you, what's the difference with this extended cut? If you guys out there on the Blu-ray, it's got an extended cut on there, extra 25 minutes.
Sure. The bigger cut?
Yeah.
There are some there's some scenes. You know what? I only recently saw that cut when I got the Blu-ray a few years back, so I went my entire life not knowing most of that shit existed. So needless to say, when I watched it for the first time, it was like a whole new thing. I'm oh my god, my favorite movie's getting even better.
Right. Well, when I the first time I watched it, I watched the theatrical, and then the second time I watched this extended, and I liked it even more. I loved it.
Yeah.
There's a select scene I wanted to mention that I teared up at. As just, I got to be the only human being in history to tear at this scene.
Let me hear.
It's when Jared Rush.
Jared Rush.
He's sending the Pete Rose card back across the thing.
Oh.
When the music's playing, when his mom's like, "I got him a birthday present."
Yeah. Oh, yes.
Man. Dude, you really break that film down. Depressing as fuck. You guys think is this the, he's actually missing.
Well, she thinks he got kidnapped.
Right. Poor kid's on a fucking, he's on a milk carton.
Yeah.
Well, he's having the time of his life, and his mom's going to contemplate suicide.
They're sitting there. Who's this Josh Baskins?
Yeah.
They're drinking milk from a carton that's got him on there.
Dude. Well, there's also another scene in that cut where you get to see a little bit more into Billy's home life. Mm-hmm. You got his mom, Frances Fisher, and she's just crazy bitch.
Making poor Billy, set the table and dish up the food.
So that's one of the scenes not in the original. Because that's Clint Eastwood's wife or whatever.
Yeah, that's not in the original. There's a scene with Robert Loggia, in his office, where Tom Hanks goes in there. I think. I can't even remember. But they talk for a while, and that's, or it might be, it's not Tom Hanks that goes in there, it's Elizabeth Perkins, and they're talking for a while, and that's not in the theatrical. Yeah.
No, I know. Solid. But, you know, when did you come to the conclusion? Number one movie of all time, favorite?
It's just, there's something about that, man. When I was a kid, I would just always watch it, you know? It's just something about
nostalgic.
It. Nostalgic. Yeah, you know, some of those movies that you grew up watching are kind of shitty, and you just kind of have an attachment to them. But that is genuinely, I think, a great film. I mean, tugs at the heartstrings, man.
Well, you know, Tom Hanks got nominated for an Oscar for it, and like,
great performance.
I feel like a movie that if that came out today, there's no way in hell that it's more comedic. You know,
no, exactly.
But you know, when you think about it, it is great acting because he really does seem like a fucking kid. You know, it's really well done, I think.
Yep.
I mean, yeah.
God, I want to go to some of those locations at the end. Sea Point Park. Oh, fuck.
Sea Point Park, New York. Yeah, growing up, I mean, I watched that movie a lot. And it never occurred to me it was like one of those critically acclaimed kind of movies. I just kind of wrote it off as just, you know, a regular kind of movie. But, I mean, it's critically acclaimed. And I didn't know Tom Hanks was nominated for it.
Nominated. Neither did I.
By the way, how great is John Hurt in that film? What a dick.
Oh,
he is the scumbag.
All bad.
Give it to me, little shit.
Yeah. You didn't have to punch me.
No, yeah. No,
I don't get it.
Let's take that bag.
Glad you revisit, though, bud. Great film.
No, yeah. I like that extended cut. Recommend it to people out there. Got the Blu-ray. Check that one out.
Do you have the musical slipcover?
I actually do, and it's still.
I do, too. Mine works, too.
Massey, that's a slipcover worth on.
Is that rare?
I don't know.
Have it.
It might be tough to find one that works now, I'll tell you that.
Okay, well, don't be throwing the word rare around.
You know, that's a common misconception among the Blu-ray collectors.
Misconception.
Oh, man. You know what I watched? We could talk about a little bit.
Porn.
What?
You know, I've always been one to kind of stray away from the hype machine. Certain series and, you know, shit comes out that everyone just talks about. It just turns me off. But I checked out Stranger Things.
Uh-oh.
Watched the pilot. You know, I want to see what it was all about. And I just kind of knocked it out. And you know what?
Verdict?
Pretty fucking good.
There we go, buddy.
Although I have to say, I do think the story aspect of it, tad bit convoluted. A little too congested, I think.
I could see
but
that.
I think it's easy to kind of look past that because the fucking vibe of it all is money.
Yep.
I can't believe that you watched it. It's mainstream. I'm not into it.
Yeah, you know, it's like, stop talking about it. You hear so much about that shit. It's like, I don't even want
to see it. That pilot episode gets you hooked. That's what
it is. You know, it's like kind of had like a, I don't know, it's like part X-Files, part like Goonies. I don't know. There was a good thing going on there, so.
Got a big ET thing from it. So
it's got
far.
Matthew Modine with white hair. What more do you want?
God, old as fuck.
Matthew Modine
that out,
with
filmings?
A shaved head. I'm currently like halfway through it right now. We're slowly pushing through it, but so far, you know, pretty solid.
Yeah, I thought it was good. I mean, like I give it like a 4 stars. It was a good show.
Great music.
Yeah.
Oh, fucking fantastic music.
Yeah, I think the plans are to. I don't think anything's been like officially announced, but the plans are to continue with those characters. I think for another season.
See, you know, I'm not sure how I feel about that.
I don't know what route it's going to take.
I think the niche is already kind of set with that season.
Yeah, I mean, won't spoil it for anyone who hasn't watched it, but the way it wraps up is kind of like. I like that. It doesn't really answer anything, but you kind of, you know, it's a good ending. I thought it's kind of open ended.
I think it'd be better going for like an anthology thing with like a new set of characters.
Yeah. No, I agree.
Yeah. I don't know. Yeah, that would make a lot of sense. You know, every set of 8 episodes or whatever is a whole new story. I mean, Stranger Things, you could use that title for just about anything. But it was good. I would recommend it.
Glad you checked it out, buddy.
Yeah,
are we doing
we
watched at the beginning?
Yeah.
This is a different starting off. But I really wanted to watch it because the kid, Mike, is going to be in the It remake. So I was kind of curious.
Oh, that's right.
He's been on that.
If the vibe of the kids in that movie is anything like that show, you know, you could be in for a treat with that film if they do it right.
That's true, yeah. And Winona Ryder, too, getting a little comeback.
God, it shocked me. She looks so old, but I guess that makes sense.
Does.
It's like I haven't seen her from forever. It's like, Grandma?
Black Swan was like the last thing I actually saw her in.
Grandmama?
Oh, I'd still go.
Oh, for sure, for sure. Just get her out of those trailer park clothes.
Yeah. He's lighting up the lights.
That's fucking solid series, though.
Yeah. Enjoyed it.
You watch anything yet?
What we watch?
I watched the pilot episode of The Nick, and I fucking loved it.
I bought
the first season, and it's fucking good.
I mean, it's been sitting in my collection because it's like one of those shows she wants to watch with me, and I'm gonna start it without her because I'm tired of waiting. I just really want to watch it.
Yeah, it was like $10 at Best Buy, and I've been wanting to watch it. Steven Soderbergh, I think, directed the first season or first episode.
I think it's his series, so I think he's doing.
Well,
it
it's
all.
His series, but I know he directed. Yeah, I know he directed a couple of the episodes. But yeah, first episode's fucking bang a dude, Clive Owen, and then Cliff Martinez does the score. So good.
It looks terrible.
It's good. I'm telling you, it's really good.
How?
Yeah, what how does it look terrible?
Is it Sherlock Holmesy fucking shit?
No.
Ew, I hate Sherlock Holmes.
Clive Owen's a surgeon, surgeon in New York, and his funding gets kind of like dropped once one of the other surgeons commits suicide, and it's like in the very beginning. So he takes over this, you know, kind of
the Knickerbocker.
Yeah, well, it's the short. It's like New York, but it's a surgery thing. So it's like
Knickerbocker
really
is a funny word or something.
Yes. What's that? Basketball? Huh?
I don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
I thought we were talking about Patrick Ewing and the Knicks.
Oh my god!
Of course you
that
did.
Was when I that was when I watched basketball. That's how old it's been.
Well, you know,
Scottie Pippen, the Bulls.
Anyway. That's classic.
Is that a Netflix thing or is that like what HBO network is that?
HBO or Cinemax? I'm
Cinemax.
Ah, sure. Oh, Skinemax.
Check it out. $10 for
got
season.
Michael Angarano in it.
Yes. That's right.
Well, cool.
Well, yeah.
I watched some more stuff too. Quite a bit. One that Filmy checked out. You guys seen this documentary, Citizen 4?
Are we really doing what we watch right off the bat?
Yeah, why not?
It's like,
make it different.
Yeah, keep it going.
But yeah, no, Citizen 4. Filmies, you watched this, I think?
I did. It's really unsettling.
Edward Snowden.
Oh, okay.
Basically, they capture in real time whenever Edward Snowden came out to the public, you know, with all the, you know, leaked all that shit.
And I didn't know that. I didn't know that's what that was about. So it caught me by surprise when he's, like, doing his live.
Oh, yeah. Filmies wrote a great review for that one. Jesus, HF, this is chilling. Really, really made me want to watch it.
No, I checked it out on HBO Go, but it's just like, I mean, I've never watched a documentary kind of like that. It's like a thriller, but you're watching everything. I mean, it's, you know, the guy's like putting disguises on and shit. I mean, it's kind of, you know, he's like afraid for his life.
Well, cool. I mean, what the government does, they'll fuck him up.
We'll kill him. I mean, it's got me really excited for this Oliver Stone movie. I hope it's good with Joseph Gordon-Levitt.
I was going to say JGL, right?
JGL.
Yeah.
Doing this weird kind of voice.
My name is Edward Snowden. That's for the NSA.
It's pretty
good.
That's
pretty good.
Yeah.
It's none of your damn business.
It's just really, you know, fucked up that, I mean, that right now. Hi. Well, my camera on my Mac. Hi.
Yeah, right. Hey. Well, from what it seems like in the trailers for Snowden, it's going to take a lot from that specific documentary in those specific moments because it's got the same reporter who broke the news. It's got the lady who documented it. So.
Of course.
Yeah, just know like, that the government has a personal following you, and they've been watching every step you took in for the past...
Every step you took in.
Yep. Sorry, it's not Liam Neeson.
Damn. All my years of Google history, fuck, I could be screwed.
I know.
No, anytime you swiped a card, you made a call, they could track
they
that all out.
For sure, yeah.
Yep, they could put you anywhere.
I know,
well,
but
what,
why...
What was
why,
the...
Go ahead.
No, go ahead.
I'll say, why get all worried about it? You can't do anything about it. You're just part of the system.
Oh, no, not worried about it. It's just, you know, fucked up to think, you know.
Right. That's depressing.
They could implicate you in a crime any, you know, any time.
Sure.
Wow.
But yeah, fucked up.
Okay.
Filmies?
Yeah, I checked out actually a pawn shop pickup that I've been wanting to watch for a while. Kind of surprised me. Warrior.
I'm Rick Harrison.
Okay.
One thing I learned after 21 years,
I'll
you never know
$1.
What you never know what is going to come through that door.
Hey, let me call my buddy who's an expert on Warrior.
I'm Warrior. So, you know, I can only give you about $2 to $3 for this.
Let me call my buddy who's an expert
really,
on
I was
Blu-rays.
Hoping to get 35, but, you know.
Shit.
Let me call my buddy in. He knows a little about Skinamax.
Warrior. Warrior fucking rules.
Solid flick. Solid fucking flick.
It is. It is.
It really
and I'm
is.
I'm not a big Tom Hardy guy.
How do you fucking miss this one, dude? This was a good movie.
Well, yeah, I just it never came across my desk. Never really had a chance to watch it. I don't think it's on any streaming services or anything. But yeah, I'm not big on the MMA, but fucking hell, the story was really well done, and I think the whole like brother on brother fighting each other thing added something new
Come
to
on.
It.
Nick Nolte,
dude,
be
my
drunk.
God. Well,
he kills it.
Yeah, he. Oh, yeah. That's the thing. He killed it. I was like, dude, he had to be nominated or something. And he was.
Oh yeah, he was.
I mean,
yeah.
he was so fucking good.
It was like a big Oscar movie that year. Like it was nominated for a bunch of stuff. I think, right?
Yeah, I mean, really, really solid film. I'm glad I finally got a chance to watch it. I think what really pushed me away is like, I always kind of grouped it with The Fighter. Because I think they came out like around the same time or something like that.
Yeah.
I really couldn't stand The Fighter, so I just...
Yeah, this movie's about 20 times better than that pile of shit.
I agree.
For sure.
Fighter's good.
Yeah.
Fighter's good, but it's more drama.
I like women.
That was hard to get through. Good God. And the whole color palette of that movie's like shit brown.
Oh, a color enthusiast now.
It was just, it made me sick watching it. Skinny Christian Bale and just like a brown shit color to the whole film.
The Pride of LOL.
1.5 out of 5.
Ooh.
That's like David Russell's best.
Well,
David Russell.
Well, that's not saying much, but.
Stupid doll.
Warrior's good, though. Warrior's good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Really solid. Anybody else?
No. Yeah. Oh God!
Should I stop?
No, go for it.
Okay, well,
whatever. We do things the way we want.
Good, because I watched Jaws fucking 2, and it's fucking terrible.
You guys
seen this before?
Yeah,
it's
I've seen them all.
Okay, well, they got pretty much the entire cast back, other than Richard Dreyfuss, and
he knew what was up.
Yeah, it's just like I'm just gonna spoil the fucking movie. I don't care what anybody says, but
dude,
okay,
don't.
Really?
No, spoilers.
Dude, don't.
I'm just kidding.
Really?
Gives a shit.
Wait, no, okay.
Dude, don't.
I kill the shark at the end.
Roy Schneider at the end, right?
No.
Schneider.
Roy who?
Roy Schneiders.
Okay. Roy Schneider at the end, right?
Schneebly.
He's
in like a little, paddle boat in the ocean, screaming at the shark to come near him. He pulls a power line out of the ocean.
Yep. Shark bites it.
The shark bites it. And beforehand, the shark has like 4th-degree burns on its face from when they caught it on fire.
Do you know what 4th-degree burns look like?
I thought it only went up to the 3rd.
Yeah, must be a different part of the scale. I've never heard of that.
Well, when it's on a fish, it's a bit different.
Fish thing.
But yeah. It's just god awful, dude. I mean, just picture that ending, Roy Schneider pulling a power line out of the ocean. And yeah.
I don't remember that part. I don't remember Roy Schneider in that
film. It's
like
you make see the exoskeleton of Jaws as he bites the
cartoon
and shit.
It does look like that. It's fucking god awful. Do not check this movie out.
What year did that come out?
1978 or something, I think. 79.
Oh, man.
Oh, no.
I think that. Is it the third one where he's in SeaWorld? I like that one.
Dude, think about it.
Louis Gossett Jr.
Roy Schneider was in the Jaws sequel and the sequel to 2001: A Space Odyssey.
Oh no!
I mean, holy fuck! Like two of the biggest films ever. They're shitty follow-ups. Poor guy.
Poor guy.
He died alone.
I'm a big Roy Scheider fan, man. But fuck those Jaws sequels. You think the guy would have learned from the first one? Just stay out of the fucking water.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Forever.
Yeah, I don't know. I just, I thought it maybe be, just a fun time, and it wasn't even, it focuses on fucking his kids.
Yeah.
Mike.
Mikey. Yep.
I know, I wanted to buy those.
Dumb kid name.
Yeah, I wanted
to buy. Have you seen the 5th one?
No.
With Mikey when he's grown up?
Ugh, is that with Dennis Quaid?
I think so. It's the one with Michael Caine, maybe. Yeah, Michael Caine did a Jaws movie, everyone.
I didn't know there were 5 of them.
Not surprising.
Or Revenge, whatever, 4 or 5, I don't know which one.
I'll never watch those because I can't.
I was going to buy those 2 and 3 for like $10 when they came out. Like, oh, that's too expensive. They need to be like $3.99 for me to.
Yeah, like it's not worth
triple,
it.
Triple pack for $7.
Yeah, I mean, puke, man. Who's you sit through the first one, you don't need to put that shit in ever.
No. Horrible follow-up, but no, that's all I got for watching lately, but. You guys want to get into some of these questions?
Well, let's progress as we normally would.
Sure.
We have on the scum line for you guys that need to call in. The number is 213-444-3766. What the fuck are you doing? And I got two over on the line. Let's go ahead and play them real quick.
Let's do it.
One from hey, Brian. Not sure which one, but
we'll which one? Pick from 10 of them.
Yo, scumbags, it's Brian Suffield. Before I get into my interesting question, I just want to say this right now, and if this goes on long, I apologize. I'm starting a new podcast called The Real Cinephiles, and honestly, the scumbags is my biggest inspiration for starting that show. So I just wanted to thank you guys for being so awesome and really inspiring me to start a new podcast. And I've done a few. They're not really that great, but this new one is inspired by you guys, so I have to thank you for that. My question for you guys today is, what is a movie that everyone else loves that you wish to love that you don't? For me, it's Pulp Fiction. I wish to love it. I love Tarantino. Everyone says that film's his best. I don't see how it is. It's just so jumbled and all over the place. I don't love that film. To me, his best is Reservoir Dogs, or I would even say Jackie Brown, which is criminally overlooked. So yeah, that's my question for today. Thank you guys so much. Deuces.
You're not going to get many fans saying that kind of stuff.
No, real talk. First of all, Brian, that means a lot. I speak for all these guys, I think, to hear that someone would call in and say that, you know, we've inspired you to, you know, do your own podcast.
It's awesome.
Yeah, that's pretty dope. So
that's like the ultimate high here. And
yeah,
like
I mean, you know, you can't compliment us much better than that. So thank you.
Yeah,
for sure.
But a movie that, you know, everyone else loves that I don't.
That's easy for me, The Big Lebowski.
Yeah, but that you want, that you would like to, that you always try and like, maybe it'll click for me this time, but it never does.
Yeah, that's okay. Big Lebowski. That, I mean, I've only seen it once. The first time I watched it, wasn't big on it. And
love that shit.
I have yet to go back to it. So, I mean, it's probably just like one of those mood things. Maybe wasn't paying 100% attention.
Right.
But, I mean, that's probably number one for me.
Interesting. Anyone else?
I got to go with Rocky. I know I always say it, but like that's the thing. It's
so
like I know it's a
like
good.
It.
Yeah, no, I mean I do. Like the story behind it, just fucking awesome. That's indie at its like finest, right?
Right.
But I just can't. I mean, I wish I could really get into it, but maybe I need to rewatch it a dozen times or something,
over and over again until you appreciate.
Yo, Adrian, I did it. Click with
stuck
Matt.
Stuck in your fucking mind, man.
Yeah, I'm sure there's a bunch more.
Let me ask you: have you seen the other ones?
Yeah,
do
I've
you
seen
like
them all.
Them?
I like four, a lot.
Okay.
I must rape you.
And actually, and five. What's his face?
Tommy Gunn. That's a good one.
Tommy Gunn. I do like five too.
Wow, that's crazy. I mean, it's like
it's just the first one is a little dated to me. So it's like a little, it's boring.
Well, yeah, not and that's dated. Just like what you were saying.
I don't know.
It's indie as hell.
How is a boxing match dated?
No, just, it feels like dated. I don't know. It's
well,
weird.
Like you said, it's indie as hell. Like the budget was minuscule. So it's.
Oh yeah, no, I understand it. Just saying. I
think it's like
it doesn't click.
Like, I honestly don't have a problem with any of them. I think I like all of them for the most part, which is surprising because I don't think most people like a lot of them.
I think they're all, you know, I mean, yeah,
the
they all have their own
like
quirk.
Weakest to me.
I would agree.
Is that
you know?
The one with what's his face?
Clubber Lang, Mr.
Yeah.
T.
Yeah, I would agree. T, I was laying them all out. The third one is the shittiest, I think. But I mean, I still think they're all kind of you know enjoyable in a sense.
I mean, that first one is a fucking masterpiece.
Oh, it is, yeah, for sure.
And you're an old man. I don't know why you're saying it's dated. You crazy.
I know, it just feels dated.
It is all weird right, how they made like fucking 8 sequels to that or however many they did.
Well, now they're doing Creed stuff.
Yeah, I mean, it's like, holy shit.
You guys were all kind of behind Creed, even Matt, right?
Creed surprised the hell out of me.
I haven't watched it yet.
I thoroughly enjoyed it.
Yeah. I like me some Michael B. Jordan.
Yeah, I mean, could have easily been one of the worst things ever, you know?
Right. Yeah.
Anyone else?
So a movie that recently came out, you know, I enjoy it, but I don't love it as much as everyone else seems to love it. Everybody Wants Some. Richard Linklater.
Okay.
Understandable.
You know, love the guy, but I don't know. It was just like that second rewatch just really turned me off.
Damn. And if anybody would love it, I would think you would be the one.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, especially because...
Dazed is like your number one.
Yeah, well, and I definitely want it to, you know, I want to love it.
you're following up one of the best films ever made in Boyhood with that. I mean, I think that's the problem with
it.
It
could only go downhill.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just like, God.
So if someone else directed it, you think you would have liked it more?
I don't think you'd have that.
I don't know.
That expectation, you know?
Okay.
I think you kind of would have went into it with more of a, okay, you know, let's see what it's all about.
I think it's too pretty, too Hollywood, you know, like dazed. That's is like what I gritty felt. Kind of feeling, you know?
Yeah.
I don't know. It feels more raw and authentic in dazed compared to like this. It just doesn't, I mean, it doesn't even, I don't know, the 80s vibe, I don't really, I don't know. It feels way too created and not like
doesn't it
already
feels like
natural.
Yeah, it feels like guys in 2016 just, you know, like
dressed up.
Yeah, I guess, yeah. Well, yeah, like, yeah, I mean, there's no...
Okay. And, like, when I was a kid, I legitimately thought Dazed and Confused was made in the 70s.
Oh, no, same here. Oh, yeah, that's, I still thought it was.
Yeah, when I first watched that, I had no fucking clue that was a 90s film. I mean, right. that's how, like, good that is to its, you know, time period.
I get it.
I agree with that.
But I think, you know, I think it'll grow on me.
Right. Yeah, I mean, that was, I remember when we did the reaction to that, I thought it looked like crap, and I really thoroughly enjoyed it. I just thought it was a really good time. It's probably one that you'll get into eventually.
Yeah, I feel like, you know, 10 years from now, you'll, you know, think differently about it. At least I hope. That's kind of, because I'm in the same boat.
And I haven't, like, watched it on my own, in my own home, by myself. You know, I saw it in the theater once, and then the one night when we were doing the movie night, so.
I was knocked out watching that.
Oh, yeah, you were.
Shit.
Can't watch Jurassic a movie without fall asleep.
Jurassic World?
We're not watching this. We're going to bed.
Hey, I'm doing some edit.
Edit.
Do
Set
it
in the dark.
Yeah, do it in the dark.
Funny you should say Jurassic World, because that's I was thinking that for this question. I wanted to love that, and I still do. I mean, I was so hyped for that movie when that first trailer dropped. Oh, God. True. Looked fucking amazing. Man, I'm so lackluster when I'm sitting there. I've never, you know, ever since then, not hyping shit up like that anymore, man. I was like, every little tidbit of information, I was all about Jurassic World. Finally, we're going to get to that original island, and it was just fucking same rinse and repeat shit story that we've seen fucking four times already.
Tell me it blows those other sequels out of the water, though, right?
If you put Jurassic Park 3 and Jurassic World next to me, I'd pick Jurassic Park 3.
Wow. See,
have you watched Jurassic World on your own in the comfort of your own home?
I've only watched it one time in the theater.
See, that's one I really couldn't stand. But I sit here and I'm like, sometimes I think, I want to watch that one again. I don't know why,
I had that, you know, after that original film, it's like, oh, what is going to be back on that? You know, we're going back to that island, the things they could have done with that, you know, and I just felt it didn't really.
They dropped the ball a little bit.
Yeah, that one little scene where the kids stumble across the old visitor center in the ruins, like that was pretty cool, but that was cool. I don't know.
And they found the car, and it was perfectly just a little dusty.
Yeah. Oh, it's only been sitting here 20 years. Let's fix it up in 5 minutes.
Yeah. I remember that Instagram post with that John Williams score.
Oh, dude, when I heard that, I'm like, this is it. We're finally going to get a fucking great follow-up. I don't hate the movie, just wasn't what I expected.
Just disappointed.
Right. Yeah, and I'm not even looking forward to the other ones. Guy, that Chinese guy running around the city with embryos. Ugh, puke.
Oh. Dinosaur embryos, anyone?
Hey, hello.
Brian, thanks for calling in, though, man. We're going to check. I'll be sure to check out your podcast. So, definitely.
Thanks for the kind words.
Appreciate it.
Got one more here.
Hey, guys. It's Jake Russell, first time caller. My question for you today is, what is your favorite sex scene in a movie? The one in Mulholland Drive is fucking lit, boys. Fuck yourself.
That's awesome.
Look, that's, first of all, I love hearing from a new caller that is so dope. So any of you guys who listen to him called
dope.
Jake?
Is that Jay?
Jay?
I'll fuck anything that moves.
Oh, yeah.
I'll fuck anything that moves.
Dude, you guys seen the Mulholland Drive sex scene, though?
Oh, yeah, so good.
Yeah,
it's only a good part of the movie.
Oh, God.
Wow.
There's actually a list going around. I don't know what the fuck is. It's somewhere in Britain or whatever, but their number one movie of the past 21st century, Mulholland Drive.
Well,
oh, yeah, I saw that.
Fucking idiots on that list.
I think it was a BBC thing.
Yeah, that's what it was.
So? They're dumb.
Well, no, I just brought it up because he said Mulholland Drive, but yeah. I know you love the film.
That diner scene, man. Diner scene scares the shit out of me still. God.
Mm-hmm. But no, yeah, Naomi Watts, butt-ass naked in that movie, bomb. What about for you guys, sex scenes?
You know, we did an episode on this, didn't we? It was one of our first ones.
I think so. Yeah,
way back.
I got a good one.
What I picked.
I got a good one.
I mean, I can go ahead.
Yeah, Wild Things. Denise Richards.
Ooh.
Nev Campbell.
Okay.
Never seen the movie.
I haven't either, but I've seen
that. You've seen the scene, though.
Seen the clip more than enough times.
Schoolgirl outfit.
Could be.
Okay, well, if we're going on that road.
Keep your pants on.
Well, I don't know. I guess it's not so much a sex scene, but like the Cruel Intentions with Sarah Michelle Gellar and Linda Blair.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well, I was thinking Harry Potter, Margaret Cho.
Selma Blair?
No.
Isn't it Selma Blair?
It might be. I don't know.
Yeah, Selma Blair in Cruel Intentions. She's the fucking
Linda Blair is the exorcist.
Linda Blair is exorcist.
Yeah.
Selma Blair.
Okay. I don't think she's playing an 80-year-old teenager, but it's just me.
Linda Blair, she had some drug issues, but fuck.
Didn't she have a real fucked up life after The Exorcist and all that?
Yeah, she's hot though. Man. Look, she got some good nudies online.
Oh, we rating those real quick.
She got turned into a fucking devil. Yeah. She's pretty bangable.
Yeah, she was bah.
What?
Yeah, what was that?
Is that your sex sound?
You watch Close Up?
You know what? I can answer this question though. There's a few that come to mind, but one that it's good. It's something creepy about it. Halloween 1978, you know, Linda, see anything you like? Right before then. And it's just, there's something, you know, Michael's walking around and they're upstairs fucking banging it out. And they have no clue that the fucking
boogeyman.
The boogeyman is walking around. Yeah, totally. Who needs their books anyways? I always forget my math book, my
math
science
book.
Totally. Books anyways.
Let me guess what your other one is.
Yeah, that's a good one though. You know, I like that. They're one final, go get me a beer.
Did you see that reaction thing I'd shared from when the original Halloween was played in the theater?
Oh, that was awesome.
I didn't see share that, but I have seen that before.
Yeah, I was like, that's
screaming
awesome.
Shit.
Yeah.
That would annoy me though. Shut the fuck up. I can't enjoy this with you screaming in my ear.
Right.
Different times though, different times.
Yeah. Whole new experience. For me, I mean, this is classic. American Pie. Shannon Elizabeth.
Yep.
Jason Biggs. I don't know how much of a sex scene you can actually call it, but
I prefer him in the pie.
He does nut twice, so
premature sex scene.
That's great stuff, man.
But I mean, I watched that one as a kid. Shannon Elizabeth. Mm.
Well, if you like that, let me recommend Jason Biggs' newest film, Amateur Night.
Gay.
Dude, this guy, you know, it's kind of a little unsettling, kind of sad that 17 years after American Pie, he's still taking on the same fucking roles, same bullshit. That's like, you know, same shit.
I feel like that's just him in real life.
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess he's, you know, he's making a career out of it. Not a bad film, not a good, I mean, it's pretty bad, but I had fun with it.
Oh my
not a bad film. I mean, it was pretty bad.
I don't care what you say. That movie is probably one of the worst of the year.
No, it's not. If you like Jason, you know, 40-year-old Jason Biggs in a sex comedy, shit. I enjoyed it.
Not that much to like Amateur Night.
Yeah, I'm waiting for American Pie, you know, 5-year reunion or something.
Oh, in Vegas?
Yeah, there we go.
Somebody's American Pie retirement home.
Yeah, shit.
I'm surprised you didn't pick Blue is the Warmest Color.
Yeah.
Oh, that I mean, that ain't even a straight up adult film.
That's a thirst quencher.
Yeah, it's something, man. You know, it took about like 2 weeks to film that first sex scene.
I don't doubt it.
That's the guy that directed that is like, he's fucking nutcase.
Yeah, like perfectionist, but also.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Okay, if you were in that situation, you'd be a perfectionist.
Oh,
guys, we're going to have to scrap the last day and do it over again. Sorry.
Not enough mouth to vagina.
Yeah.
Well, he made a masterpiece, so good for him.
We go home and do some editing.
I'm looking at these dailies and
love that shit, man.
Oh, man.
But appreciate the question, man. I appreciate you calling in. Always, like Seth said, like hearing from the first-time callers. The number for you guys still need to call in. You guys can be a first-time caller, too.
Yeah,
if you call in at 213-444-3766. I think we got a few over on Twitter. Want to get on those, Seth?
Oh, is that supposed to be me?
Yeah.
Well, film me. You got Facebook pulled up?
I do, because I'm doing my job.
Do that first. Sorry, lacking a little bit. I'm just not into this anymore.
Hashtag do what you want.
Wow. Yeah. Go ahead. You do those first. We'll get back to Twitter.
Okay. We got one here from Brady Spencer. Yo, scumbags. What is the most uncomfortable experience you've ever had while watching a film? Whether it was the film itself that made things weird or the situation around you. Keep up the slick work. Total support. Thanks.
I took a chick.
In the ass?
I mean, like, I had known her for, like, I mean, you know, I've only met her one time. It was, like, the first time I ever went out with her. Went to see
Tinder date?
No, this was a while. I went to see Zach and Mary make a porno. That was pretty uncomfortable and strange for someone that you're just kind of getting to know. But, you know, it is what it is.
It's always weird watching a lesbian scene with your mom.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hey, do you want to see Randall get shit on?
Yeah, I'm like, God, we could, you know, I could take this chick to see something else.
Didn't work out?
No, she was kind of ugly.
Oh, my God.
Hopefully she's not listening.
I was way more interested in Elizabeth Banks on the screen.
Seth and Fatty make a porno.
No. Not fat. She had a big old nose, though.
Oh, my God.
Alcoholics always do.
God, so bad.
Sorry to you ladies out there. We love all women.
Of course.
Love all you girls. But we got...
got what?
What?
Sorry, I blanked on everything. But Cannibal Holocaust, one of the most uncomfortable, unsettling, you know, things to ever witness. If you guys out there have seen it, the turtle ripping scene is enough. I mean, but that's like, you know, mild compared to some of the stuff that goes on in the film.
Great film.
You guys like penises being sawed off.
That was awesome.
That occurs, you know, you got...
Seen the Pain Olympics?
Yeah, that's exactly what I was going to say.
No, filmies, we're not all fucking getting in the chat at 8 a.m. asking for Pain Olympics videos.
I haven't eaten my breakfast yet, but send me some Pain Olympics stuff.
Too bad. Yes. Too bad.
Yeah, I remember that. Have you guys
see a hatchet rip?
Have you guys seen this suicide video?
I think that was a Seth and me thing.
I'm really obsessed with Christine Chovic right now.
I am.
Does anyone know where I can find the actual video?
I don't think I ever asked that one.
Have you guys seen Senator Bud Dwyer blow his head off?
That's a good one.
That was it.
That was the one that you brought up. You're like, oh, look at this one.
That was the one that you sent Nick G about, like, the freaking bus accident. Oh, my God. I watched that, and I wanted to fucking throw up.
I don't even remember.
Suicide fans out there?
Oh, my God.
Suicide Squad, right?
Suicide Squad.
But you guys, uncomfortable while watching the flick.
I think I watched American Pie with my mom one time. And that was about it. Nothing real crazy.
Oh, man. Shit. Yeah, no, that's awkward, though.
Then I got a boner, and she's like,
she put a sock on it. He's watching illegal channels.
Yeah.
So you saw your dad's dick, and your mom saw your dick.
Yeah, what the fuck is going on?
Real close-knit family over there.
So that's how it is in their family.
Alice, Henry, I'm sorry if you're listening to
this. Alice and Henry.
So that's how it is in their family.
Oh, that's fucked up. What about you, filmies?
Like I said, some lesbian scenes with my mom. Serbian film wasn't too comfortable to watch.
Oh, you should have ate some sushi with it.
Yeah, let's poke out this guy's eye with my dick.
That's a good shot.
Love it.
Never seen that one, thank God.
It's filmed really good.
It's fun. I mean, but
yeah, I don't know how well you can film a cock, you know, going into an eye, but
oh, yeah,
you'd be surprised. The cinematography
is overwhelming.
It's good.
There's an art to the cock shot.
They use the red camera.
Gaspar knows a master of cock shots.
Ugh. All right, so we're gonna have extreme cock close up.
All right. Okay, move on. I'm getting sick.
We got one more here from Greg Stott. Hey, scummies, keep up the good work. Enjoyed your interesting chat with Patrick Bryce. I really enjoyed Creep. What was your initial thoughts when you first watched it? All the best.
Initial thoughts on Creep. Super impressive because of what it is. You know, super simple.
Right.
Not a whole lot going on, but effective. That was my initial thought. Like, this is pretty impressive.
Minimalistic, but effective.
Incredibly enjoyable.
That fucking ending.
The ending's fucking awesome.
Great. Just love every, you know... Like the concept, and like Seth said, just the small aspect to it. You know, two guys with a camera went out and made that.
It's one of those movies where you're like, fuck, I should have thought of that.
Right.
Right.
You you know? It's like,
well, I mean, it's also like, especially me, I make big deals about long takes, but you know, these guys who are, you know, they're not A-list actors, but they're pulling off these long takes where it's just, it's impressive.
Yeah, and you know they did it probably because that's the only thing they could do. They didn't want to, you know, split it up or cut it up or anything.
Right, it just seems so natural. I'll just do it,
yeah. Yeah, just one take.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, Mark Duplass was great in that film, though.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It's a good one.
He's creepy.
Yep.
Crappy. Oh, yeah.
Appreciate you listening in on that, Greg.
Yeah, glad you enjoyed that, Greg. And any of you guys out there who, you know, might not have known about Patrick Bryce or what he's all about, you know, I hope you learned something from that. We're able to, you know, check out Creep or The Overnight and, you know, discover stuff.
Yep.
That's what it's all about, bud.
Good stuff.
What do you got on Twitter, Seth?
All right, I'm ready this time. M4 Movies. Which remake of a movie would you want to see remade, but properly? Okay, so take a shitty remake and, you know, do it right.
God. There's so many.
You know. Not that I want to see. Okay, you know, that works because I did want to see that. When that came out, I was fucking excited for it. Love the original. That'll never change. But I thought, well, let's see what, you know, someone else's vision is going to be, but fucking shitty. So, yeah, someone comes along and does that, does it right. Sure. I'd love to see that. It's one of the worst movies ever, though.
I would say Nightmare then. Nightmare on Elm Street.
Oh, you're not a Jackie Earl Haley guy?
I am, but not for fucking Freddy.
We had the same conversation last week or the week before.
Oh, let me look. I look like a zygote.
Great.
Oh man, this is a really fucking hard question for me.
It is really
because bad remakes, I just like kind of flush from my brain. I guess. What was the one they did not too long ago? The Thing. Did they do some kind of?
Was it a prequel?
Oh, okay.
Is that what Mary Elizabeth?
Yeah, still have that sitting on my shelf unopened.
God. I've never seen it, but I'm sure it can't hold a candle to John Carpenter.
That's what I'm saying. He's never felt the need to fucking
put that
in. Gotta
sell some of your blues.
Yeah. You know.
Yeah.
I like Mary Elizabeth. That's the only reason I'm holding on to it.
Yeah, that's a hard question, bro. I'm sorry I'm not able to answer that one around the spot. I really can't think of anything. Any good remakes? Sorry.
Yeah. Oh, well.
Okay. Got a couple answers in there. What do you got? Something?
I was gonna say, slit my wrist.
Oh, please. Calf Films, yo scumbag. Calf Films here. My question is, what is your favorite Tim Allen performance?
Oh yeah, Tim Allen retrospective coming up.
God, best
That'll
Tim
be
Allen.
Another
movie.
Shitty one.
That's you know, tough. Tim Allen is not much of an actor. Let's be honest. Same performance every film, but I love the guy.
I do too.
His
best treasure. Movie, though, I mean...
Like, what's your favorite movie? Maybe not his best.
I've probably only seen Jungle to Jungle and, like, Santa Claus.
I mean, you know, the best film he's been in, like, film-wise, is probably Toy Story, but I don't really count that just because it's just his voice, you know?
True.
But that is, I think, hands down his best film. But live action, I mean, I think you got to go with, like, the Santa Claus, right?
I fucking love that movie.
Yeah. But let me tell you.
I like Christmas with the Cranks, too.
Hey, that's an underrated one.
Yeah, I do.
Jungle to Jungle is fucking awesome. That's actually on my list for a topic that we're going to get to later on.
Mimi Siku.
Oh, so good. Where the fuck is that Blu-ray, man? Come on.
Oh, we'll get there.
No Wild Hogs fans?
No.
Saw it once.
Oh, well.
Wasn't not, wild about it.
If you're not a fan of the Six Wives of Henry LaFay, that's your own problem.
I was trying to talk about that one for richer and poor, for richer or poorer.
The Amish that? One,
Kirstie Alley.
When they're Amish,
yeah, they're trying to rob fucking an Amish community,
oh so they pretend God. To be Amish.
Man, yep. Tim Allen's awesome.
Tim Allen with a fucking Amish beard.
Mm-hmm. And you got God, he's 63 years old. What the fuck?
Is he really?
Yeah.
Holy shit!
And you guys, Home Improvement fans.
Pot does a good job.
Yeah.
Cocaine does a good job.
Love Home Improvement.
Man, the episode where oldest son gets busted for weed. Oh, shit. It's comedy.
Fuck that guy.
I'm going to have to find dramatic. That clip. That sounds
good. He's got it hidden under the porch swing, and there's like a camera shot of his hand reaching to get it, and then fucking Jill grabs his wrist, and it's really dramatic. Really dramatic music. So.
I'm sure the idiot's looking over the fence.
Oh, yeah. Wilson? Yeah. Rest in peace.
Didn't they, like, never show his face the entire series?
Or? No, they showed it.
Okay. No, they showed it.
They showed it. You're wrong.
I have the toolbox DVD collection.
Yeah, it comes with a bin for it all in one tool.
I want that.
I always wanted that chick. Who? Mama from that show. Yeah.
Which one? Well, Pam Anderson?
Oh, the chick after Pam.
They're before. Both fire.
Or was she after or before? Before?
Pam was before.
Okay, Pam was the first, right?
Matt knows.
I know.
I'm an expert.
I was a huge fan.
I was there when it aired.
Well, yeah. if you're not a fan of Joe Somebody, that's your own problem.
Joe Somebody.
I love Tim. Galaxy Quest, anyone?
Ooh, I like Galaxy Quest. It's a good one.
Yeah. Lucas Green. Are there any movies you would like to hear a commentary by the original director and main cast that doesn't currently exist?
Every movie one. I like.
I have one for this. Stanley Kubrick on The Shining.
Oh,
yeah. Well,
or 2001.
Any of his movies.
I just like, you know, because there's all those fucking theories and documentaries about fucking The Shining, you know. Just like to hear like him and fucking Jack Nicholson on a commentary would be crazy.
That's a demonic film.
I could see him doing like a Gene Wilder and just being, the theories. It's all insane. Yeah. It's crazy. None of it is true.
I just wanted to make a movie.
Guys, up to some bizarre shit in that film.
Yep. Classic.
I can't think of anything off the top of my head, man.
Chaplin.
Damn.
Commentary over silent.
So what were you thinking here, Charlie?
Oh,
nothing.
I don't know. It was almost 100 years ago.
Silent. Completely silent.
Oh, right here I farted, but you couldn't hear it.
Well, this, you know, it exists. It's coming out, but it hasn't been out so far. Can't wait to hear that Boyhood commentary. I'm excited for that one.
Yep.
Be listening to that.
I hope that documentary
is worth it.
Why does
he hate squash? I want to know.
Yeah. Like, Marco Perella. Great performance from Marco Perella.
Oh, this squash.
Can we get him on the podcast, please?
Completely improvised. He just said, I hate squash. It was genius on his part.
Mr. Perella, can we talk about that? I think that does it for Twitter.
That's it. Right. For the questions on social media. Make sure you guys follow us on all the social media platforms if you guys have not.
At Cinema Scumbags.
Instagram.
C-I-N-E.
Twitter. Stuff like that. But
Skinema.
Some shit that I heard this week. You know, I'm big on this Blade Runner sequel that's coming out. Denis Villeneuve. And they just added Jared Leto to the cast. I don't know how you want. How do you want to say
Jared
it?
Leto.
Jared Letatoto.
Jared Leto.
Jared Leto.
That's it. But I think the guy's
Gosling
great
and
actor.
Leto?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Roger Deakins and Denis Villeneuve.
Oh, God. Sounds so good.
Have they started filming this yet?
I don't think they have. Well, I'm sure the director's doing promotion on that new one he's got coming out.
Rival movie.
Oh, okay. That's right.
But it is, I think, slated to come out next year. So I don't know. I hope it can be good. I think the guy's a pretty solid director. And, you know, I'd like to see him take on some kind of, you know, because it's going to be the big, they're going to target it, big fucking blockbuster.
Of course.
Which the original was like a flop, I'm pretty sure. You know, became
like
a cult
classic.
Movie.
Yeah.
So I wonder if it's going to be called like Blade Runner 2 or it's going to have its own title, you know?
Yeah,
right.
I'm not sure.
Because like, if you call it Blade Runner 2, is that going to attract a big enough audience, like a current audience? You know,
right.
Like a lot of people don't even like your casual moviegoer. I feel like a lot of people don't know what Blade Runner is. I mean,
yeah, I would definitely say that because I hadn't seen it myself until a few years back. But,
you know, I feel like it could just be like they could just title it something totally different, and it'll be a sequel. But you know, you won't know that by the title.
Runner of Blades.
Yeah, you know, who knows?
You guys fans of Jared Leto though?
I think he's
great.
Yeah,
he's great in Panic Room.
Mm-hmm. Cornrows.
Cornrows.
That's got to be the worst.
Corn rolls.
He's in fight.
Best film.
He's in a Fight Club though too.
Yeah.
That's great. Buyers Club.
Requiem.
Dallas Trainee Club.
Yeah. Didn't he come out and say that he wasn't like satisfied with the Suicide Squad movie or something?
I think they chopped all the shit
fucking,
out.
Yeah. He's like, did I even act in it?
Yeah, they cut out a bunch of his scenes. And with all the promotion and all the hype behind his performance, you know, it's...
Fuck the critics. That was good.
I don't get what all the hate is about. I thoroughly enjoyed it.
Hashtag fuck the critics. I loved it 2 years ago. But,
loved it.
No, Jared Leto, Blade Runner. I think that's cool. I'm down with that.
Yeah.
Yeah, sure. I mean, I'll watch. You know, I don't care.
You're down with a Ryan Gosling Blade Runner movie, Seth?
You know, Ryan Gosling, yeah, whatever, whatever.
Yeah,
whatever.
I thought you liked the guy now. Didn't something, like, come to where he's like, oh, Drive, pretty good?
Well, no, because of, what's it called?
Nicholas Winding Refn,
yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's right.
Ryan Gosling, I'm just not as high on him as everybody else. He's okay, I guess. I don't know.
Yeah. I don't think he's, like, great, but he's fucking good.
Yeah. I mean, you know, I guess Gangster Squad was a good film.
Yeah, if you take it up the butt.
4 out of 5.
Gangster Squad sucks. Filmies likes it, though.
I do. Was that one that you watched, like, or listened to at work, and that's why you gave it such a good rating?
No, it wasn't.
What's not bad, bad paying
it
for?
Was, you didn't have to see it fucking Sean Penn's ugly ass nose.
It was one of, not one of those quality ratings. It was one of those enjoyment, like, dumb enjoyment ratings.
I feel like if there's any Ryan Gosling movie I'm going to like, it's going to be that one with Emma Stone coming out.
Ooh, La La Land?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, did you see the new trailer for that?
Oh, it looks great.
Well, I sent it to you, so I hope so.
Well, yes.
You better click on everything I sent.
Fuck, dot.
Chills.
No dots. It was just fuck.
I know, but yeah, no, that looks fucking great. The first trailer was amazing. This one's probably even better.
Even better.
El Bell.
Which Ryan Gosling, La La Land, you like even better?
So that's cool.
Front,
you know,
back, right. Sides.
Fuck the heck, size, Spidey.
Well, the guy has a lot to live up to, you know, his follow up to Whiplash. So, Damien Chazelle.
Ah, oh, right.
Yeah.
We're not talking about sex scenes still,
Is Harrison Ford gonna be in this?
Yeah, he'll be in there.
He'll be in a magical alien wheelchair or something.
It'll just be his head floating.
Just no,
guy out of the airplane.
Is he doing every reboot?
They're just passing the torch, you know. So then Gosling will take over the franchise. I'm sure, you know, he's there.
What
to fucking
franchise? Why is it a franchise now all of a sudden?
Yeah, I'm sure it's gonna be because well, if you've seen it, the world's like, you know, it's a huge concept, you know.
Oh,
you didn't think they were gonna franchise it there, Seth?
Yeah, that's if they can franchise it. They'll franchise.
Everything
it.
Is a franchise.
Well, I mean, the story's like, yeah, you just have to rewatch it.
Jesus Christ.
Give me French fries, not franchise.
I bet that microphone smells like shit from all the times you burp on it.
Dude, the pop filter, it reeks. You know, it's funny you should say that because just last week when I was about to record, I noticed kind of a foul stench coming from the pop filter.
Ew.
You know what's funny is when I used to record bands and they would be screaming all the time, and I'd go take off the microphone, I could smell the pop filter like 5 feet away.
Ew, my God.
Gross. There'd be like debris in the fucking filter.
Throat debris. Oh, I puked in my mouth.
A little spritz of Febreze on the old pop filter.
There you go.
I can't get over
that. And those shorts, too, on
the give me the French fries, not French fries.
Maybe that's the stench you're smelling.
They need to go in the wash.
Ew.
I didn't wash them the other day after I fished.
How many times do you wash your clothes?
I'm just wearing reek right now.
I'm just wearing them around my house. I'm not going out public with them.
Yeah, well, you fart and shit while you're home, right?
Who doesn't? Are you kidding?
Exactly. So it's not like it's not like staying inside's any cleaner.
I'm just saying. On Sunday, I hooked a bass in the gullet, and it was bleeding on my shorts, and I washed them. So
it's fucking gross.
God, you're dumb.
Jesus.
They're just lounge shorts. I'll get a load of laundry here in a couple days.
A couple weeks.
I gave them 2 weeks.
Oh God. Oh Seth, huge. I got something to tell you, bud.
I'm listening.
October 4th, guess what's getting a Blu-ray release? October Sky, yeah. Jake Gyllenhaal and Chris Cooper.
What?
Yes.
What?
Finally, man. That's
sick. Cross that off your list.
Yeah, I hope that wasn't on your list. But
it wasn't. Fans of that film, anyone?
I've seen it once, but I liked it, I thought.
I saw half of it in school one time.
Laura Dern?
I'd pick it up for that $10 price.
It's a great film.
Chris Cooper is amazing.
Chris Cooper, man. Just a, you know, I've said it before. Just a great prick character actor.
Underrated actor.
Yeah.
Yep. Great. Oh, Frank fucking Jake Gyllenhaal.
Me too, son.
And Shermanator's in there?
Me too, son.
Oh, okay, young filmies.
Yeah, Shermanator.
Oh, no.
It's a good one. I think everyone watched that in school.
Oh, yeah. I think they made you.
Is that a rainy day movie?
Science class.
Yeah. Sure.
Does have a rainy vibe. I don't know why that hasn't been released. You know, like you said, they fucking showed it in school. Like everybody, that's
a popular
movie, you'd think, but
yeah.
Maybe because they good. Only showed it in school.
Yeah.
The thing though, I have a feeling with that one. I could watch it now, and it might not. It might not be as great as I remember. You know, that's my concern with it.
I think it probably still hold up. I think it's actually like good. You know, it's not.
I mean, I remember it being great. Fuck, all the times they made me sit through it, I was never bored with it. Like I fucking loved watching that shit.
Yeah, I don't want to work no coal mine, Dad.
Shove that rocket up my butt.
Then there's some other Blu-rays that are coming out. I don't know if you guys fans of The Karate Kid.
The first one.
Well, I know you guys like the first one, but we got Karate Kid Part 3 coming out.
Oh, I don't want to see Hilary Swank doing fucking judo chops.
Well, actually, Part 3 still has Ralph Macchio.
I don't see Jaden Smith.
Then the next Karate Kid's getting a Blu-ray release. That's the Hilary Swank one.
Can we just say for a second, fuck that Jaden Smith fucking Karate Kid. Fuck it.
I've seen it, but isn't he a trans community member now?
I think he might be
transitioning.
There might be some,
I've been hearing something up the old Smith vine lately.
Yeah,
so.
What have you read in the local trans websites there, Seth?
He wears like dresses and shit. He might be swinging that way.
Could be. He could have one of those little Kardashians. Dumb thug.
God.
could be.
But no, like the original Cry Kid, fucking classic. Love it. That's like, don't even feel dated to me.
I could do the whole I know Ralph Macchio, but I'm not going to get into that. So,
oh, what do you know about him? Let's hear.
I went to school with his niece.
Oh, cool.
How do you know him?
Well, because he would pick her up from school every now and then. So I've met him before.
Did you go talk
just
to him?
Just lie through your fucking teeth.
Yeah,
like
but I was a fucking kid. I was an eighth grader, seventh grader. When it happened, swear to God.
You're just lying to your fucking teeth.
Nika Tenorelli, if you're listening, Nika Tenorelli, just call in and validate my story, please. Thank you very much.
Those obsessive lying problems.
Well, first it was a drug problem. Now it's a lying problem.
I know. Like, what else do I have? Jesus.
You're lying about the drugs now.
Ralph, can you sign my journal?
Every story.
No, I didn't give a fuck about movies. That time.
I was trying to fuck everything that moved.
I was a band. I liked guitar.
Stabbing kids with glass eyes.
No, that was high school. I graduated that. But yeah, anyway.
Well, she was just for like go hang out with, you know, Ralph Macchio. No. Ralph Macchio.
But that
Ralph
was
Macchiato.
Yeah. Ralph Macchiato.
Ralph
Macchiato.
Man, you guys ever seen Beer League?
No.
Unfortunately.
That sounds familiar.
Not Beer Fest. I'm talking about the much lesser known Artie Lang's Beer League about the softball team.
Oh, I'm sure it's much better.
Central about 50 fucking times. Thanks. 50 too much.
Yep, Artie Lang, Ralph Macchio, and Aunt Jackie.
Let's do a Artie Lang fucking retrospective.
Wow.
Oh, next up.
Dirty Work?
That would be about one breath.
Shit. I'm excited for October, Scott. I don't know how we're talking. Oh, and Karate Kid. No, I'm not excited for Karate Kid Part 10.
Those actually have never been released, so it's cool. I know the first and second one have like a little set they come with, I think. I actually own it, so I know they do. I don't know why I said I think, but
interesting.
Yep.
I think.
But no, that's like mostly it for the newer Blu-rays coming out. What do you guys got coming to next week? Next Tuesday.
It's another shit week. August 30th. The only thing that I see really coming out is the Phenom. That's coming to Blue. I know both of you guys liked that one. I enjoyed it as well.
Cool.
Yeah. Shameless, the complete, I think, sixth season, comes out to Blu-ray.
They actually put that show on Netflix for you guys.
Did they?
Want to check it out. Yeah, the
I haven't seen the last, like, two or three seasons, so I need to get caught up on that.
I need to check out the last season. It's one of my favorite shows that Showtime probably did, for sure.
And then a couple Criterions, The Immortal Story comes out, and then an Orson Welles one, Chimes at Midnight. Yeah, Chimes at Midnight comes out.
Cool.
Yeah. Slow week again.
Interesting.
Go figure.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, we've got a lot on this list of what's coming out theatrically, but that doesn't necessarily mean it's good. Let's see. Oh, we've got The Sea of Trees, Gus Van Sant's new film.
That's already coming out?
Yeah. currently holding, last I saw, 5% on Rotten Tomatoes.
Okay, it's all coming full circle because they put the trailer out. I hadn't seen a trailer for this, like, at all. And then it comes out, like, fucking 3 weeks later. It's gotta suck.
Yeah. Sorry, Gus. Good Will Hunting is your best film.
True. Seth was right.
Wait, what are we talking... Sorry, what were we just talking about?
Sea of Trees.
Oh, yeah. Disappointing.
Yeah, it's already coming out.
Oh, you know?
The trailer dropped, like, a couple weeks ago. It's weird.
Here we go. The Mechanic Resurrection, starring Jason Statham. Oh, yeah. Fuck that shit.
Oh, that Jason Statham?
Yeah, homes.
Can you name one movie by him you like?
No.
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 I actually like Crank.
I did when I was, like, 14.
When I was 14.
Yeah, I did like Crank.
Oh, fuck. One I'm actually kind of excited about, I'll probably check out, Don't Breathe.
Ooh. Looks great.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh god, Hands of Stone, the boxing movie with Robert De Niro, where he's like has no hair.
Oh yeah,
boxing movies.
The legendary Roberto Duran and his equally legendary trainer Rare Arsal change each other's
better than
lives.
Muhammad Ali.
Rare Arsal.
The movie looks shitty, but De Niro looks pretty good in it. I could have went to an early screening with Brandon the other night, but missed out.
You didn't go.
But anxiety set in.
No, I didn't want to see Hands of Stone,
mm-hmm.
and I was busy, I think, so.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
John Krasinski-directed film. We'll skip that.
No, dude, that looks fucking good.
You think
Wait,
so?
What's this one?
It's got a bunch of acclaim out of Sundance.
It's called The Hollers. I guess his mom gets sick, something like that.
Well, his mom's, like, on her deathbed, and he's about to have a kid, like, all at the same time.
Okay.
And, like, yeah, so he goes back to his hometown. It's a good little indie movie. Anna Kendrick.
When I saw the trailer,
like State.
Hater.
When I saw the trailer, I thought it sounded interesting, but it's not doing too well as far as reviews. It could still be good.
Mm. Anna Kendrick's a hack.
She's a hot.
She's all right.
She's a hot. cool. Barack Obama film, Southside with You.
Oh, I thought this was going to be Barry with Ella Coltrane.
Yeah, I was going to say, this ain't the Ella Coltrane one. No thanks.
Yep.
Which one?
Barry.
I don't see that anywhere.
It's not coming out right now, but at some point.
You have to wait.
Darn, can't wait for another Ella Coltrane film.
Oh.
Oh, you talking shit on Ella? You're off the podcast.
Yeah. Nice knowing you.
Turn in your badge.
Don't you have some college friends to hang with?
What else?
You guys are my friends. There's a bunch of other stuff, but nothing really. It seems we could go into. It's worth it. Not that any of that other stuff was really worth it either.
Is it ever?
No, it's not.
When's Nerve coming out to Blu-ray?
Ooh, hopefully never. Hopefully it's straight to DVD.
Jeez.
Shut up.
Where's the Emma love? Come on, buddy.
Oh, Emma love.
Oh, Emma, you know I got mad love for you, fam.
All right.
Okay.
Well, something I wanted to get into. If you guys are avid Blu-ray collectors out there.
Oh, I am.
You may have pay attention.
Pay attention.
You may have noticed that quite a few movies have been getting Blu-ray releases. Like, a lot more than usual, I think, anyway. And a lot more, like, good stuff. So I wanted to kind of go through.
Karate Kid 3.
Oh, you know, or like It, or fucking
very
good
true.
Fucking movies. My Girl, Free Willy.
Hey, true. We're Blu-ray collectors, bud.
Yeah, don't get it twisted.
Sorry, bud.
Don't get it twisted.
But I wanted to kind of go through. You know, let's talk about some of these fucking Blu-rays that still have yet to be released.
Okay, are we doing are these movies that you want to see, or?
Yeah,
the essentials that need to come out. Because I kind of put together some that I want to see that aren't necessarily, great films.
Yeah, no, these are more ones that I would personally want a release for. So
kick it off. Let's hear one.
What you got? What do I got at number 5 is...
Yeah?
Yeah?
It's a great Daniel Stern directed film. You guys may have seen it. Surround. It's rookie of the year. The Cubs.
Ooh. Wow.
Okay. I should have picked that one.
I don't. I have that on my list too.
It's cool.
Now you're talking. Now you're talking.
How has this not been released? This has got, it's got everything. It's got everything.
It's cheese.
It's
got everything. For sure.
It's got the fucking, I mean, Thomasine Nichols, you know, funky butt loving.
He's a great villain.
Just like interesting. I would not be surprised if they put it out lately, seeing as the Cubs are good now.
I know. They'll probably win the World Series and the fucking movie will finally come out.
Yeah, the Cubs World Series Anniversary Edition.
if they got to win the World Series for the Rookie of the Year coming on Blu-ray, then fuck, I hope they win.
So be it.
I need that movie.
Yep,
I agree. Yes. You could take that one to the bank.
I was great film.
Love that. Grew up watching it. Yeah, we did. We reenacted the little shot.
Oh, yep. Yeah, fuck. I forgot about that. We've actually been there, kind of. That's awesome.
That's crazy. Yeah.
Just a fun great movie. Film.
Man.
But I've never owned that DVD for some reason. There's never really a good way to watch it on Netflix or anything.
Can we talk about the underrated aspect of that film? The great Gary Busey and his finest performance.
Chet Stedman. I don't do autographs anymore.
Every time he fucking pitches, like the camera zooms in and says, yeah.
You can tell every pitch is painful.
I think he was the first person to get veneers. I think he's always had fake teeth.
Yeah, he pitches and then like the camera cuts to him and he's holding his arm. Like,
I've never seen a real pitcher look like that. He looks like he's close to death.
Yeah.
I know, he's old as fuck to be an MLB, man. He looks like a fucking old man.
What is the average age of that? Like, when do you retire? How old are you?
Dude, I mean, like, you know.
35, maybe?
Yeah, you'll get some pitchers that go up into their 40s, but he looks like he's fucking 50 years old in that movie.
Yeah. He was, because he was.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, it's Billy Frick.
Yeah, I love when they're on the airplane. Oh, what are you eating? Oh, best Salisbury steaks ever had in my life.
You want some? What are you having? Chicken fingers. You want some?
Someone made a great mashup commercial on YouTube. Chet Stedman Salisbury steaks, like a fake product. Laugh my fucking ass off watching.
Oh my God.
What's the line with the fat dude from fucking Heavyweights? Is he like, oh, she drinks a lot of milk.
Milk does that body good. That's a great Patrick.
What happened to that kid? Yeah, what happened to that guy?
I've tried finding Patrick LeBrec. He disappeared.
Of course.
God, just turned into an episode of Unsolved Mysteries.
Where did Patrick LeBrec go?
New movie's going to drop. Fucking Mario Yedidia.
Patrick LeBrec.
That was a 90s haircut that he sported, too. Like, that was strictly 90s.
Old school. Oh,
the buzz cut. It's like the Buzz from Home Alone.
Great fight scene. Fucking scrap next to the boat. Yeah. Oh, thanks for joining us, Mr. Celebrity. Great film.
We're not going to work on the boat just because you say so.
That shitty ass fucking boat with smoke coming out of it. Like, like the worst boat ever. Who gives a shit?
And that third best friend's teeth. God. But Rookie of the Year at number five for me. What do you got, Seth?
Well, I'm just going to put these together. This will be a double pack. This should have came out.
Double pack.
Problem Child 1 and 2.
Yes.
See, I was going to put that, but I thought it was coming out, so I didn't want
to. It was supposed to at some point, and then you never heard about it.
Yeah, they pulled it or something.
Essential. Grew up watching them, man. Love both of them. They're fucking funny as hell. Great Michael Oliver performance.
That's the my dad. One.
How the fuck did a movie like this get made? You know, because its target audience is kids.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, I think this movie contributed to, some of the dumb things I probably did as a kid.
Right. You know? What a strange looking dog.
Oh, yeah. You want to play rough, huh?
I mean, I absolutely fucking, I love those. I watch them over and over again. You know, the first one's the best, but goddamn, the second one's great too, man.
Oh, it's up there in like my top 20 comedies of all time. Probably,
really? I mean, it's fucking hysterical. God, the damn Love Rock and Murph and.
It's like a dirty comedy, though, for kids, too.
It's, yeah.
Well, he fucking throws the cat and fucking, just a little smoky.
God damn it, man. I've said it before, but I love John Ritter. Miss that guy. It sucks that he died the way he did. Way too young. I mean, guy was great.
What did he die from? Do you guys know?
Something with his heart. Coronary. Aorta. Oh,
okay, yeah, that's right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Ugh.
Yeah.
Just randomly, too, like when he was doing that Eight Simple Rules show, he just kind of said, I need to sit down. And
yeah, his wife, Amy Yazbeck, that's in both the Proud Child movies, runs like a foundation for him. She's fucking hot as hell. Still looks good.
I like how they used her for both like main parts in the, in the movies.
Do that to like, a few years ago. Like, no shit. Fucking great. She's like the bitchy high maintenance wife in the first one and then the nice nurse in the second one.
That's range.
Yeah. Yeah, Gilbert Gottfried. Come on.
And you know, Michael Richards.
Yeah.
Oh, first yeah. one. Oh, massive. Man.
Whoa! I just got a new paint job in here.
Because it fucking burps. God damn.
I love when he fucking it has him in the car and he opens up his suitcase. These are fucking toys. He's like, he's like, we're going to go on a crime spree.
These are kitty toys.
Yeah, kitty toys.
Got me right in the prune.
Guns, hand grenades, and even dynamite.
So that's that would be top on my list. And like Nick D said, I mean, you know, in terms of my, you know, when you're talking about my favorite comedies, God, those are two movies that, you know, make me laugh out loud every time. So.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Fucking great.
Nice.
Well, I'll go ahead and go. Basically, my list is just DVDs that I have that I think would be good on Blu-ray. No particular order, but the first one is a Steven Spielberg, or shit, Stephen King adapted movie.
Whoa.
It's called Hearts in Atlantis, starring Anton Yelchin and Anthony Hopkins. Basically, the story of Anthony Hopkins is like a psychic, and he's on the run from the government because they want to use his mind to help them. And he kind of hides out in this home with Anton Yelchin and his mom, and they kind of grow a little friendship. And it's really touching. It's a good film. It's actually pretty decent. I rewatched it recently. And I didn't think it was going to hold up, and it did, and I can't talk. It's a
cool bud. It's cool, bud.
Yeah, it's
I haven't
a,
seen that one.
It's a
I need
flick.
To watch it.
It's actually on YouTube for anybody if you want to check it out.
Oh.
It's based off a Stephen King like a full-length book or a short story or
You what? Know, honestly, I'm not sure. I'm not sure.
Is that guy like the best author or what? Jesus Christ.
It's got to be. You know, well, I always think with that guy, like, think of all the shit that he's created. Like, really, what is going on in that guy's head? Yeah, there's some sick shit going on in his head. I mean, he's a genius, but for one guy to come up with the shit that he's come up with.
It's just a range of stuff, though, because for the longest time, I thought it was just, like, scary stuff. But, I mean,
I don't know. There's that one surprised me if that got the treatment eventually, because it seems like more of his shit. You know, there's three coming out with It, Cat's Eye, and there's another one from Stephen King that's getting Blu-ray treatment. Yeah. So,
literally nobody I know has ever seen it. I don't know how I came upon it though. It's good.
I gotta peep it.
Anton Yelchin proven why he was an up and comer.
That's sad.
Yeah,
not that great behind the wheel though.
Well, he wasn't the wheel.
Not that great behind a car.
Not that great with vehicles.
Stop. Not that great in front of a car.
Put it in park. It. What about you, Matt?
All right. Well, from a movie like that, let me give you the synopsis of this next movie. A day in the life of a group of teens as they travel around New York skating, drinking, smoking, and deflowering virgins.
Whoa.
You're in the skating shit.
And giving AIDS.
I know, I'm told. And giving AIDS. We're talking about Larry Clark's kids.
Oh.
Yeah.
I've never seen that.
I fucking love this movie. I don't like Harmony Korine, but he was the writer of it, and Larry Clark directed it. But I saw this like in 1995, I think, when I was like a wee little fifth or sixth grader with my buddy on it. Like, he had a VHS of it.
1932.
No, I remember seeing it on VHS. He's like, you ever see this movie, kids? And I'm like, no, like, what is it? And he showed it to me, and literally like, the beginning scene, I'm not really spoiling it, but the beginning scene is this guy fucking this girl, and they look like they're 14 years old.
Yeah.
So,
because they are.
I mean, I'm sure they are. I don't know what the actual age was of the girl, but she looks like young. But yeah, that movie just stuck with me, and it's a shame it doesn't have a Blu-ray release. Like,
it's just that movie seems so dirty.
Yeah,
no, that was the next part I was going to bring it to. That movie will make you want to take a shower.
Yeah,
like
yeah.
easily.
I think you say but that every so time good. You talk about it too.
It's so real because it's like real. It's like you're watching just a documentary,
dude.
It's
when
fucking
they
weird.
Fucking go to town on that dude with the skateboard,
yeah.
Whew, I don't want to get jumped.
Gummo, anybody?
Same guy, right?
Gummo makes me throw up. Yeah.
Spaghetti and strawberry milk in the bathtub, anybody?
Oh, and the water is like shit brown. Oh,
fucking mongoloid face.
But yeah, I mean, if you guys are into indie flicks, this is like as indie as it gets. Kids, 1995.
Is that streaming anywhere?
I watched it on YouTube.
Yeah, I'm sure you can find it on YouTube.
I don't know. Let's check that out. Isn't fucking Rosario Dawson in there?
Young Rosario and young like Chloe 10? Savini. They're like 15, 14, 16. I don't know how they are.
Interesting. She sucks.
Who?
Oh, she was not my favorite part of the movie.
Rosario Dawson.
But Chloe Savini's in it. Like, she's the main character.
I
and
love
she's
her. Young. Oh, wasn't that like her start?
Yeah.
I love AIDS.
Then you should check out Kids.
I'm going to watch it. Next up on my list.
Awesome. What's that? Put me next up for number four on the old list here. Lords of Dogtown, a movie I fucking love. You seen it, Filmies?
I enjoy it a lot.
Oh, this is a revelation. Awesome. I didn't know anyone else actually liked this
movie.
I used
to have it on PSP, UMD.
Oh, I just thought you were against this one, Matt.
I just didn't like Heath Ledger. He was like the Joker in it.
He's fucking great, but
sucked.
But I mean, he's playing a real person.
Joker.
Right?
He was just like some hippie douche.
Yeah, but if you guys aren't familiar, this is about the guys that invented like bowl skating. Fucking, you know, Jay Adams, Tony Alva, Stacy Peralta, big names in the skating world in the early days. So, great film. I thoroughly enjoy it.
Yeah,
I don't really know why it hasn't. I think at one point it had a. Slated for like a Mill Creek release or something, but it just never happened.
I don't know either.
Well, I thank the fine folks over at Mill Creek for sending this to me.
It's like definitely came and went. It doesn't really have an audience. It's not like even a cult movie or anything, really, I don't think.
You know something, though? When I see shit like Heavyweights and other bullshit get a Blu-ray release, I hold out hope for anything, you know?
Yep.
Right.
If like anything could get a Blu-ray release.
Ooh. That's true.
For sure.
Sad. Yep. Lords of Dogtown sadly doesn't.
Sadly it will, doesn't. Bud. It will.
But
well,
what you got, Seth?
Well, you know, just another one that not a particularly good film, but reminds me of, you know, the good old days, being 12, 13 years old. I'm talking about a Shia LaBeouf Disney film called Holes.
Holes, yes.
Dig it up holes.
There you go, Bud.
I fucking love that shit. Like I said, not the greatest film. I'll admit that. It just, I don't know, does something for me. Takes me back to the good old days.
Caveman. Yeah,
here, drink this splooge.
I have the DVD of that one. Yeah, it's a good one.
Who thought of that name? Come on now.
I don't know, right? It's kind of surprising that that doesn't have a... I do feel like that will get one at some point, you know? Disney title, Shia LaBeouf.
Disney. Yeah.
And it was really popular when it was out, you know?
Yeah, it was another one I watched in school.
Horrors.
Horrors starring Shia LaBeouf.
That one's based on a book too, right?
It is. Yeah. Yep. I don't know, man. Great time with that one. Still fun. I watched it, I don't know, like a couple years ago, I think, and still a good time with it.
That shitty song. I'm the caveman. I'm the new man. Stop.
That shit was lit.
Yeah. At least he tried and quit early at the rap career.
There's some good people in that though. Sigourney Weaver and, you know, John Voight.
Yeah.
Yep.
She's in like, I think she's in the Ernest movies.
Yeah, you got the fucking, what's the guy's name from Heavyweights?
Tim Blake, or I don't know.
Yeah, I think it's something. Careful. I think you're almost right on that.
They can be addicting.
That dude was actually really good in that Oh Brother
World. Oh, yeah. Tim Blake Nelson.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, so, you know, let's see Holes on Blu-ray.
Yep.
Please.
Yeah, sure. My next one kind of piggybacks off of Nick's number five, Rookie of the Year, but let's make it a double pack with Angels in the Outfield.
There we go.
Angels in the Outfield.
Sports movies that I like
is actually pretty fucking solid after rewatching it recently.
Dad, what are we gonna be a family again?
The way I'm sitting, maybe when the Angels win the pennant.
Dude, like, get who on your says fucking... that?
That movie always bumped me the fuck out when he go to the court and he's fucking, you know, signing him away or whatever.
He just doesn't want you. That's all it is.
Roger, give it up, you dumbass.
It could happen. God,
I really like Miguel.
That score in that movie, though, is so, so good.
JP doesn't like riding cars. He used to live in one.
I was in the tailpipe.
Dude, you know something? I mean... Yeah, great music for one, like you said, but
mm-hmm.
it, you know, it is a, I don't know, I feel like I watched that like not too long ago and I didn't like it as much, but you know, for what it is, fuck, I watched the shit out of that when I was a kid.
Oh yeah.
Did we stream that one? Because I thought the same thing.
We might have. I think that might have been how we watched it.
Right. I know I did it for my baseball movie night.
Yeah.
No, I think we did stream it because I think I remember watching it with you guys.
Yeah. It's good though, man. Fucking, what's Tony Danza. Yeah.
Oh.
Yep.
That
ending though.
Dude, that movie is kind of a downer when you really think about it. Fuck, you know, Tony Danza sitting there about to die and he doesn't even know it. God, always bums me out.
That's everybody though.
He's one of us soon.
Yeah, it's like, fuck.
Anything with angels, you know.
God, that's dark.
Yeah. Yeah, right? Like, it's an uplifting kid.
He's going to be one of us.
Yeah. Christopher Lloyd telling you that the guy's about to fucking croak.
Well, and that part during the playoffs where JGL stands up and starts doing the angel wings thing, like, you think that's going to be cheesy, but fuck, with that music, oh.
Did you do it? Did you do it with him?
Probably when I was younger, wouldn't doubt it.
Oh, I definitely did. I know
that would fly at Yankee Stadium, so I'll throw a ball at his head.
Stupid, typical Yankees fan.
Yeah, for sure.
Great film, though. I mean, I would be down with a double pack. Throw that on there, man. And the guy from Fast Times that recently died like a couple years ago is like the assistant. He fucking funny as hell in that
movie. Oh, yeah, definitely.
Sits on the nachos.
Yeah.
I'm saving them for later.
Good stuff.
Nice. Okay. Go ahead.
I just have to hum this great tune right now
in the middle of the podcast.
I can't get out of my system.
Been there, bud. It's all good. What you got, Matt?
All right. So another. Okay. Cool.
Go ahead.
I just love it so much.
All right. So another classic film. Okay.
All right.
Another classic film from my youth. I don't think any of you guys have seen this. It's 1989's The Wizard with Fred Savage.
What?
Savage.
Did I say Savage?
Who's that again?
Fred Savage.
Fred Savage. Luke Edwards and Jenny Lewis. Oh, God. I'm tired. I've been up since 4 a.m. I'm sorry.
Fred Savage.
Which one is that? Is that about computer hacking or game? What
no,
is
it's
that?
About gaming, bro. It's about games, bro. So it's about this is a great story plot.
Savage.
Fred Savage, right, has a little brother who's autistic who they send away, and he is like a freaking genius when it comes to video games. Anyway, he breaks them out of like their little home to go to California to see the dinosaurs. And on
Why
the
are you
way,
enunciating everything?
This is a real fucking movie. And on the way...
Cabazon?
Yeah, to go to Cabazon. And on the way, he finds out that he's a fucking really good gamer and he can make money off of it. So he like kind of enters him in a championship for gaming. This is right around Super Mario like 3.
Sounds cool.
That sounds pretty solid.
It's cheesy as fuck. It's terrible, but I loved it. I even bought like a bootleg DVD of it back in the day because I wanted it. And it would be great if it was on blue, but it's cheesy. Like it's fucking.
It would be great
terrible.
If it was on blue.
It'd be
like,
great. But it's so bad.
Another classic Fred Savage film,
Little Monsters. Yeah, Little Monsters is up there.
Howie
too.
Mandel.
Let's just double pack it. Can we double pack that one?
Definitely, man.
A lot of double packs on this list. No, I would fucking totally love to see Little Monsters, but young Fred Savage, dude, in any of that stuff, he's fucking great. Kevin. Yeah,
totally.
Totally.
That'd be cool. That'd be cool. I'd be good with that one.
Number three for me, one that's actually only on DVD. That's why I'm saying it on the list. But it's a Leonardo DiCaprio, Robert De Niro movie, This Boy's Life.
Okay.
I just really fucking like the movie. I don't know why it doesn't have a blue. Like I've said, I think in the past, it would sell itself. Yeah, De Niro, Leo, you know.
Pretty decent.
I mean, you got to think, you know, of most like kid acting debuts, and that's Leonardo's. Fucking, you know, his acting debut.
Great.
Right.
Sure.
So it's pretty solid, though. A coming of age movie about a kid living in the 1950s, him and his mom, single mother, and she meets Robert De Niro's character and pretty much gets with him, and he's an abusive fucking father.
And he's a true prick in that movie.
He really is. Is it empty?
Good one.
Yeah. No. I think I don't buy many DVDs, but that's one of the ones that I do own. So. This Boy's Life, great film.
Totally.
Sick.
You know, anything with DiCaprio would sell itself on Blu-ray, which, you know, goes hand in hand with my number three pick. I believe it's actually a Blu-ray in some fucking foreign country, but I ain't paying $60 to import it. It doesn't count unless it's an American release.
Yep.
What's Eating Gilbert Grape?
Ooh.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah. 1993? Yes. I mean, come on.
That just needs a criterion.
I thought you were going to say The Beach.
No. That's a guilty pleasure, but kind of shitty. But What's Eating Gilbert Grape, I mean... Fuck. I love that movie. I've seen it countless times. It's fucking great, man. Great performances. Fucking Johnny Depp, Leo D. I still think, you know, God, I mean, if I'm ranking his performances, that's I can't, I mean, that's like up there for me. Shit, it's such good acting, but.
What do I always say when we talk about this movie?
I don't know.
About Leo. his performance.
Full retard.
He looks like he stinks.
Yes, thank you.
He
that's
does.
That's how good
man.
Of a performance he did,
dude. That's you know when Johnny Depp fucking beats his ass in the bathtub. God, that always shit. It's hard to watch,
Mama,
man.
Mama, wake up.
Yeah,
that seems
yeah.
destined for a fucking Criterion.
It's got to be a Criterion.
So. That's what I'm saying. You know, it kind of you get that same kind of like vibe. You know, they put out some other movies like from the 90s that are you know like that same sort of vibe. You know.
Yeah. No, there's like sure. a King of the Hill, Steven Soderbergh. Right. Kinda. Right. I mean, it's yeah. a you know different thing, but yeah.
Yeah, like that kind of like what's the one with River Phoenix and
My Own Private Idaho.
Yeah, yeah it's kind of that. That's you know those kind of movies. Mm-hmm. Like I definitely could see that coming out. But Criminal, that's not on a Blu-ray. If you haven't seen that, I mean, stop what you're doing, man. After you listen to this,
that's another one. You stamp Leo and Johnny Depp on the cover. I mean,
that's what I'm saying, right? I mean,
boom.
Why wouldn't you grab that?
And that's yeah. good Johnny Depp like era.
Yeah,
it's fucking pirate shit.
Film. It wasn't filmed here, but it takes place in Iowa. It might have been filmed here. I don't know.
Probably.
Sick.
Vagabond.
Sick.
Who directed that?
Lassie Hallström.
Okay, there we go.
The only reason I know is because I have it pulled up.
A dog.
Yeah.
Yeah. What's eating Gilbert Grape, man? Fucking phenomenal.
Classic.
My next
I don't
one.
Like grapes.
My next one, one that most people probably wouldn't agree with, but I know Matt will, The Village.
Oh, you beat me to it.
You know, like I said, most people don't like this one, but I fucking love it. I think it's really enjoyable, a really great score. And it was Bryce Dallas Howard's first film. And Joaquin, great.
Still,
Roger yeah. Deakins. Come on, it needs a blue.
Oh, yeah.
That film looks fucking phenomenal.
Oh, yeah.
Never seen it.
I mean, it looks great.
What's like it about, though?
I know the plot twist, though.
Ah, you're fucked, man.
I know. I didn't mean to read it, but I stumbled across it.
Go ahead and explain it to him.
Well, knowing you, you probably did.
Okay, yeah. You want to...
You love spoilers.
Oh, don't spoil it. Don't spoil it.
Well, you know what? I hope you're ready for that Light Between the Oceans fucking whatever that movie's called. That's dropping that spoiler right in the chat.
Is there a spoiler to that?
Yeah, what?
I thought it was just a like a straight
what movie's looking forward to. They're getting all spoiled.
No.
I'm not going to tell you now.
Spoilers.
But no, what is The Village about? Like, give us a loose plot, Matt.
There are these people in the, what era would you call it? Filmies?
Colonial.
I guess it's, thank you.
Oh, Colonial. I'm out. Never mind. I hate that shit.
Okay.
All right. Well, then, anyway, Jesse Eisenberg's in it.
Oh, yeah, I'm back in.
There you go. All right, cool. There we go. So it's a Colonial Night Times.
Moves?
Jesse, $10? Worth it?
Make up your mind. I'm going back to bed. Fuck.
Anyway, read the fucking synopsis. See if you want. God damn.
Just fucking watch
man.
The movie.
Make your own decisions.
Back to me so soon. At my number two, we
I
have...
I think I'm next. And, but,
Oh, sorry. I was thinking it was your movie.
Ooh, exciting.
Oh, well,
go
I've got to be the first one to get my list out.
I fucked it all. I fucked it all up.
I fucked the call up.
What do you got? Number three, man.
One, I just honestly looked at my Blu-ray shelf and found one. It's Ivan Reitman's Thank You for Smoking. It's weird that this one doesn't have a blue. I loved this film. I think you guys saw or Nick D, maybe you saw it
in
LA.
Yeah, we saw part of it at your crib.
You were like, oh, it's all right. I mean, I like it.
I was into what I saw. I would you know, go back and check it out.
Yeah, Aaron Eckhart plays like a tobacco lobbyist and, you know, it's kind of satirical. Katie Holmes is in it, which is weird because she's in never in anything. William H. Macy's in it. J.K. Simmons is in it and Robert Duvall. So you got like an all-star cast. Yeah, all-star cast. So it's weird that it doesn't have a blue. So I just kind of threw one in there for the top five. Yeah,
cool.
I want to peep that.
Yeah.
Hey, peep this out.
Hi, here.
Back to me so soon at my number two, The Independent Gym. Sam, you're a piece of shit. I don't know the line, but Mean Creek.
Oh, Mean Creek.
Was it? So you're a lying sack of shit, Sam.
Chapped cunt.
You're a fucking lying son of a bitch, Sam.
Yeah.
Millie, you chapped cunt.
This is what Culkin is this?
Rory.
Okay.
Rory. Yeah.
You got Rory Culkin. You got Scotty from Eurotrip. And it's basically, you know, Rory Culkin's being bullied by Josh Peck, so his older brother and his friends plan to take him on a little trip out to the woods and humiliate him.
What a twist that is. Josh Peck being the bully.
Have you seen it before?
No, I haven't.
Okay.
Oh, that dude, you'll never look at fucking Josh Peck the same way again.
Yeah.
scary.
Physically, he's fat.
He's fucking scary in that movie, man.
Oh, yeah. Daddy splattered his brains. Yeah, no. Check that fucking movie out, Filmies. That ending. I'm not gonna get into it, but great independent gem that not enough people have probably seen or ever talk about. He's a blue.
You know what? I mean, it is great. The fucking other Culkin brothers. We've said it before, but you know, I know Macaulay gets all the talk, but the Culkin brothers, they're fucking good, man.
Yeah,
yeah.
I dig they're most awesome. Of the shit they're in. There's a movie. This is off topic, but it's from 1998 with Kieran Culkin. And who's the kid from, I don't really know Mighty Ducks too well. He's like the big dude.
Oh, but you know Mario Yedidia.
I know what you're talking about. I can't think of his name either.
Okay, it's got Kieran. This movie's got Kieran Culkin and that guy. Kieran Culkin is like this, he's got like some physical problem. He's in a wheelchair. It's like a great coming of age thing, man. It's called The Mighty. It's got Meatloaf in it. Couldn't recommend it enough. It's a great fucking film. Nobody's seen it.
Kieran's Watch probably it. The best out of all of them.
Got Meatloaf. Couldn't recommend it enough.
Listen to me. I mean, I'm telling you, this movie will fucking make you. I mean, it'll fuck you up. It's like Simon Birch.
Oh, that's the fucked up movie.
Yeah, it's great. Love the Culkins. Love Mean Creek. Good choice.
Meatloaf. Mean Creek's great. What do you got for two?
You know, I have a lot of things I could put here. I talked about it earlier. I was going to say Jungle of Jungle or you know shit like that. Whatever. I could say that. But I'm thinking. You know, I always think that like animation. Looks the best on fucking Blu-ray.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
When you take something that was hand-drawn or whatever in the computer. Sorry, I'm joking over here. But some of those old, like, Disney movies or the old animated movies that they've transformed to Blu-ray, they look fucking amazing. This would probably never happen, but there's a my favorite animated film ever, 1982. It's a 30-minute short. It's called The Snowman. I mean, this movie is a masterpiece. This is an animated masterpiece. I love it. I watch it every year. I mean, it really is like a phenomenal film, but little rough. You know, the DVD kind of looks shitty. If they pop this, you know, remastered, it would look so good on Blu-ray, open it up for a whole new generation of people to watch. So kind of a wild card pick there, but The Snowman, 1982, needs a Blu-ray, best animated film ever.
Nice. I really still need to see that.
Yeah, I mean, dude, when the holidays roll around, it's like 27 minutes. It's worth it.
Yeah, I've seen people just like talk so highly of it. I think it's on Prime, actually.
Yeah,
it is.
I remember watching it as a kid.
Yeah, it's on Hulu, too. I fucking watch it every year, man.
That's probably based on a book, too, right? Because I feel like I remember that book as a child.
Yep, yeah. It was a book that the guy wrote, and then they animated it.
Was it like one of those books where you pull the thing and it changes the landscape of the book?
No,
it literally looked like the cartoon. Like, I mean, it's just straight up
oversized fucking, you know, kids books with pictures and shit. But god damn it, dude, it's emotionally moving. Masterpiece.
God damn it, dude.
This is the most romantic movie.
I just love movies.
This is the most romantic scene I've ever seen.
Animation looks bomb on Blu-ray, though, so that's why I kind of
always does.
Awesome. Yep. My next one, I think this actually has a release in Canada or something, but it's never had an official Blu-ray release that I know of. Just Friends.
Ah. Really? That's your number two?
I think mine's in no particular order. I just kind of put it in there.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
I think that is on Blu-ray, bud.
I think it's a Canadian one, but there's been like no like official USA one. I mean, it's like up there as one of my favorite comedies. It's just so fucking funny. Ryan Reynolds at his best, you know.
Yeah, it's true.
Dusty.
It's so quotable too. I mean, I can't watch it enough.
What's the other guy that's in there? The brother to Ryan Reynolds.
Oh yeah, Chris Marquette. I don't know,
like,
his name.
Yeah, I think that's right.
He's funny.
What's with that bullshit, man? Like certain countries, like you know, fucking Canada gets that, but we don't.
Because Canada gets it.
Get it? Yeah.
Well, probably because Ryan Reynolds is Canadian. I don't know. Maybe something.
They get comedy, eh?
Like a. Borat definitely needs a Blu-ray release, but we don't get it here. Some foreign countries got it.
Yeah,
Kazakhstan. Right.
Fuck Paul's kids. Go Canada.
Yeah, I mean, I love it. I think it's great.
Nice.
I was really hoping we'd get a Blu-ray for Van Wilder 2, The Rise of Taj.
Ugh. The Rise of Taj?
That even get a VHS?
My name is Taj.
You can get Van Wilder 1 in that fucking dump bin anywhere.
Anywhere.
Literally
anywhere.
They have it at H&M.
First DVD I ever bought, FYE.
was Van Wilder?
Yep.
Damn. That's a good movie. Anyway. Well, along that line, my number two is Three Ninjas.
Ah.
Can we get a Blu-ray release for Three Ninjas?
I'm talking about Surf Ninjas.
You're talking about Surf Ninjas, which is the lesser of the two. But still,
dude, what's with the
decent.
90s ninjas? Everything ninjas,
That was what it was all about, man.
Oh, I was obsessed.
Yeah, I wanted to be a ninja.
I watched every ninja thing I could find.
I know me and Nick D love it. Three Ninjas.
Oh, yeah. Tum-Tum.
Needs a blue. Tum-Tum. Rocky Colt. Come on.
Hit him. Light him up. But, yeah, Three Ninjas, awesome.
Three Ninjas, blue.
Yeah, I've watched that, but I don't really... I don't know. I think I've just like seen bits and pieces of it over the years when I was a kid.
I mean, I haven't rewatched it in like probably 10 years, so it could suck ass, but
probably.
Oh, it's still great, dude. When I rewatched it, the whole robbery, whenever they're the hostage situation,
dude.
You know, that was one of those I watched countless times as a young kid.
I wanted a trampoline in my room. That's how bad I. That movie.
All the sequels, though, not really cutting it. Not even that
Hulk
Hogan one.
Well, because they kept changing the fucking kids.
I know, right?
That Hulk Hogan, what an actor.
Yeah, that High Noon at Mega Mountain. Ooh, great. Oh.
We should do a commentary if there ever comes to Netflix.
Oh, yes. I heard that. My number one, Seth had said it kind of earlier, Mighty Ducks.
Ooh.
I would like to see a box set for this. I think that it could get the treatment like Heavyweights, probably. Maybe a Skype call of Mike Vitar from jail, some kind of interview, you know.
I'm shocked by that pick. I thought I knew for sure what you were going to say.
What do you think he was going to say?
A certain, you know, Richard Linklater trilogy.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Well, I just figured I was like, I'll fucking set it for 60 episodes. I'll try to pick something different.
Yeah, no, I hear you because I specifically picked something else just for that reason because I figured it would have been said way before it got to me. But we'll just we all want to see that. We're not even talking.
Yes.
But no, Mighty Ducks, I mean, I grew up on the shit. I can't believe that don't have a release. I think that it would get, you know, I think people would buy it.
Hell yeah.
Oh, for sure, man. That is weird that doesn't
But I would want to see, like, you know, the triple pack. I think that'd be kind of cool.
Yeah. Which one's your favorite? I think the first one's like a legitimate good movie.
Yeah. I like D2, though. I really do. Knuckle Puck.
Oh yeah, well I like the whole aspect with the original film. You know how like he's playing against his coach that coached him as a kid, and you know just like all that's fucking really good.
Triple Deke
should have been nominated for some Oscars. Yeah, Triple Deke edition. I like that.
Triple Deke. Really, edition.
What year was Mighty Ducks?
92 was the first one, I think.
Quack, 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 Mr. Duckworth.
And then the second movie, they're the Olympic team. They were that good. After their first season.
Okay.
But, yeah, great film. What do you got, Seth, number one?
Well, you know, we talked about some baseball films in this segment, so I'm going to go with, you know, one of the classics that needs the treatment. 1976, The Bad News Bears, Walter Matthau. You know, classy, kind of raunchy little league. They suck ass, and it's funny because he's a drunk.
These kids taste like paint.
Yeah, he's trying to coach these kids, and you got the great Jackie Earl Haley riding around on a dirt bike. It's a classic.
Yep.
I can't believe that doesn't have a release. That's like probably one of those early sports films, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, it's really weird.
You were talking about dirty movies. That one looks dirty, too.
Oh,
like, watching it, I just feel like dirty.
None of those kids shower.
They're remade.
Yeah.
The kids, though, I mean, goddamn, that movie's pretty edgy. Kids are racist. Coach is a drunk.
Yeah.
But fuck, sounds man.
Good times.
Yeah, it's a fun time.
Fun.
So, you know, if I wasn't picking the Before trilogy, you know, I've got some wild cards like The Bad News Bears that I'd love to see.
Yep. That'd be a good one.
Awesome. My last one, Seth already said it, Problem Child 1 and 2.
Yeah.
Little double pack. Yeah.
Yep.
Michael Holmberg commentary.
Yeah. I need to see that, man.
Michael Richards commentary.
Mike Cam.
Mike Cam.
LaWanda.
No. LaWanda.
Like, if
the
I can.
The hell is in this salad?
Get one commentary, it'd be John Ritter from the grave.
From beyond.
John Ritter.
Poor guy.
You know, for the longest time, Michael Oliver was like missing. Nobody could find him.
Yeah.
No one wanted him.
Then they came across his katana picks.
Oh, I tell you though, man, the chick from the second one, Trixie,
mm-hmm.
she turned out all right. You know what I'm talking about?
See for yourself.
Didn't they do an anniversary thing? They did a picture, a photo
yeah. opportunity.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
I've seen a picture right now with hot ass fucking Amy Yasbeck groping fucking Michael Oliver.
Ooh.
Great stuff.
I'm looking this up.
Classic, baby. Classic.
What's your last one?
What a strange looking dog.
So we already talked about The Village. It's my number one, but also before those trilogy, people. First two, before films need it. So yeah.
Soon enough.
Oh yeah, it's only a matter of time. Yeah,
it's inevitable.
Richard Linklater said they're working on it.
Yeah, it's coming. You got Boyhood finally. That's it's gonna be right behind
it. Oh God. Michael Oliver's facial. What is he doing in that pic? I'm sure we're all looking at the same pic.
Wait,
right?
Do you see the one with Amy Yasbeck holding on to him?
Yeah, and she's holding a dog too, the other girl.
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Oh man. They actually took a picture of the chick from the birthday party in the first one.
Surprised the jacket still fits, Mike.
Man, Amy Yasbeck, fucking no.
Isn't that the jacket? Him and John Ritter have matching jackets in the second movie.
It's kind of a disturbing photo op, but
yeah.
Oh shit.
Good stuff.
Gotta love it. Yeah. I'd fuck her. God.
Looks like she's fingering that dog.
Oh my God.
I haven't had a smiley pie in 15 years.
Smiley pies.
It does look like she's fingering the dog. What the hell?
You guys gotta look up this Problem Child anniversary photo.
Good
set.
Times.
Yeah. Well,
she looks like a really hot Peg Bundy.
Yeah.
Anyway. Yeah. No.
No? Not so much.
But yeah, no, that's pretty much it for that top five little thing we wanted to go through. But there's tons of movies still don't have a Blu-ray release. Definitely need it.
Oh my God, Murph?
Oh, sorry. Yeah. Saw that. Yeah. Saw
that. It's a well baby.
Oh, baby.
Fred, you gonna pee pee the diaper?
He looked like he smelled like shit.
Dude, when he karate kicks that sign at the carnival, holy shit, that's fucking funny. That's gonna be the clip at the beginning of this episode. Guaranteed, that's gotta
there
be.
You go. Okay, yeah, that's cool.
Yeah, that was a fun segment, man. There's, you know, so hopefully some of these will get the treatment. Wouldn't surprise me. You know, most of them seem pretty logical. So,
yeah, let us know down below what you guys want to see on Blue that hasn't been released yet.
Tweet us, get at us. You know. Tell us some of your anticipated titles or shit you'd like to see get the HD treatment.
All right. You guys ready to get this?
Not really.
Iraqi stuff done with? God, Matt, what a pick. Get into it.
I'm sorry. Michael Cera liked it, so I figured it was a safe.
Yeah, I'm consulting the average score on Letterboxd, and this is like a 4.4 or something. This is universally loved.
Well, okay, so Filmies, can you describe it? Because you were the only one that liked it.
No, I changed it.
Did you?
Yeah. Oh. Basically, what it seemed like to me, from what I could get, was it was like a documentary about real life events with
starring the real people.
With the real people.
The movie's Close Up, by the way.
Right. Yeah. Sorry.
Yeah. Sorry.
Close Up. Yeah, it's a documentary about real events about a guy who impersonated a director, lived with a family, and basically used them. But the documentary was with the real people, like acting out how it happened.
And that's the thing. So they intermingle like the actual trial footage with like, you know, flashbacks and stuff.
Reenactments. People that were in the events.
So it was tough for me to kind of follow along, you know, to begin with.
Well, like Filmy said, it's a documentary, but it's like, is it? You know, part of it is, but part of it's not. It's like weird, you know?
Yeah, but
like,
and they, sorry, go ahead.
No, go ahead.
Well, they intersplice like the real trial in with it.
Yeah.
So it's like, it's a bunch of different things going on at once. It's a little convoluted, hard to follow.
And I was telling Nick D this, like I pulled up the Wikipedia with the movie so I can kind of, you know, follow along. The first fucking 30 minutes aren't even in the Wikipedia.
Yeah, I did the same thing.
Like it's him finding a tape recorder for 10 minutes.
I'll be honest, I didn't make it past that car scene.
Well, the car scene almost seems obsolete. Scene. Like it has nothing to do with anything.
No, nothing.
Should have just skipped over it.
Yeah, there's a paint can that fucking flies down the street for 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Fucking knocked out watching that.
That one, it seriously kind of made me sick. I was like, I don't like Iraq. I don't get what's going on right now. I'm sicked sick to my stomach.
Sicked. Taliban won this time.
Yeah, I think that equally is the worst movie that I've had to sit through on this segment.
I'm sorry, guys.
Worse than Walkabout.
Michael Cera, go fuck yourself.
First of all, the comparison of Walkabout as like a piece of shit is bullshit for one.
Well, you haven't watched this one, so you wouldn't.
I didn't like Walkabout, though. I know you did. You loved it.
Put the phone down.
What?
Put the phone down and watch the movies.
What are you telling me this?
Serious, Seth just got real right now.
That's your problem. You fucking looking at your phone too much.
I think it's all right, bud, if I didn't like it.
No, just look at your phone.
I would give it a revisit. I know you fucking love it. It's just like close up. It's universally
better than looking at his clothed dick.
I think you guys get a little distracted watching movies.
I don't know what you would know about anything like that, but
you know, I'll see you a lot, you know, something on Facebook. I'm watching something, and then like, you know, on my sidebar, I see you all this activity from Nick D. It's like he's not watching the movie.
What are you talking about? Like, you're monitoring me?
I see it. I'm not monitoring you. I see it.
What's going on here,
guys? Guy gets distracted. Here, Seth's tips for watching movies. Ready? Put your phone on airplane mode for an hour and a half.
Coming from the guy that can't get past 10 minutes in a movie.
Seth's lecture if you don't like a movie you liked.
No. This is not about liking the movies I like. I just think it's
I give it a rewatch, bub, without my phone.
I think you would enjoy, you'd find yourself enjoying more things if you put the phone away.
I like a lot of movies.
And take a piss before the movie starts.
What is this? Why don't you post and watch Warm Bodies?
Okay. Sometimes. Okay.
You know, sometimes things happen.
Shut up.
You're done. Shut up.
I've got heartburn.
Oh, my God.
But, yeah, everyone's overall thoughts on Close Up.
my fucking
waste
Facebook
of my time.
It was rough.
Shit.
I wish I would have watched the other one I actually rated.
You know what the problem with this was?
What?
Oh, Gopalo.
Oh.
Hey, he made a cameo, but you wouldn't know.
Yeah.
Hey!
He was the bicycle.
For some reason, I thought from the cover it was about some old samurai story, but pretty wrong.
Pretty wrong. What do you got?
The Zatoichi series?
With the Zatoichi?
Yeah, start with number one. Oh, that's what we're going. That's Matt's pick, Zatoichi.
All of them.
My pick is actually going
to be... Blind Samurai?
Just pick. What are we watching?
A film from the year 1986, River's Edge, starring Crispin Glover and Keanu Reeves.
American 80s.
Coming of age murder mystery.
Crispin Weirdo.
I love Crispin Glover.
Yeah, I've always wanted to check this out. I've never like really seen it available to stream or anything, and it's actually available on Hulu right now. So.
Scumbags Obscure Trivia Fact. What was that, episode 7, 8?
It's 15.
It was that far, huh?
Yeah.
God, time goes quick. You're talking shit and you know it.
Yeah.
You said as an opening to an intro, that is a clip from River's Edge.
Yep.
God, what's going on with Crispin Glover in that movie? Looks like homeless or something.
Is he the only person named Crispin ever?
Gotta be.
Crispin Waugh.
You know, the movie Hot Tub Time Machine is a piece of shit, but when he's throwing around that chainsaw, you're like waiting for him to cut his hand off. That shit's comedy.
Yeah. It's kind of fucked up, you know. I'm sure you guys know the whole Back to the Future story, how he didn't want anything to do with the sequel, and they basically just fucking like CG or cut him in.
Yeah, he's still crying about that.
Oh, yeah. But no, River's Edge, 1986, available on Hulu, coming of age kind of movie. Switching it up, it doesn't always have to be some Turkish fucking...
Yeah, I'm done.
Nobody said it had to be either.
Ooh.
Yep, That's what we're checking out. Hopefully you guys tune in and listen next week to hear our thoughts.
Anyone ever seen Crispin Glover's, it's probably the most legendary David Letterman appearance ever.
Yeah.
Have you?
Yeah, where he's kicking at him and stuff. Yeah.
He came in like character for this fucking obscure movie that nobody saw. And he's like doing karate kicks and shit, acting weird as fuck. And Dave is just like, he's like flustered. They don't know what to do.
I'm going to have to look that up because I love those fucked up late night interviews.
I'm telling you, that's one of the best. And then they had him on like 10 years later and he comes in like dressed normally and he's still acting fucking spooky as hell. Like he's just not saying anything. He's just laughing. Legendary.
I listened to him on The Nerdist and oh my God, he's weird. He's a weird fucker.
He's a spook, man. Also pursued a musical career. Look up his smash hit, Clowny Clown Clown. There's a great
How do you know all this stuff?
He's got a lot of time at work.
I'm a Crispin Glover.
Oh my god. What was the one horror one with the rats? What is that one called?
Willard.
He's quick to answer.
Big fan of Like Mike.
He knew it.
I love Crispin. Was he in Like Mike? That's the low point.
He was
the low point.
Foster home guy. Your game is over.
Yep. That one I'm kind of looking forward to watching that one. So
same.
I'll be able to chime in on it.
Stoked.
Cool. Stoked.
I guess that's fucking what?
Stoked you're participating.
Always love to hear about it, buddy. Hashtag do what the fuck you want.
do what you want with your own life.
Do what you want.
I think that's it. Right? That wraps it. We did what we watched already. Already knocked that one out.
Yeah, I kind of like that. Change of pace, you know. Starts off nice conversation at the beginning of the episode.
Yeah.
Maybe we'll adopt that going forward. We'll see.
Yep.
Any closing thoughts, fellas?
Can't wait to be back next week.
Can't wait.
I love this podcast.
I just love it.
I love you guys. I love you girls.
I love it, man. You know, the rest of this year, I think, is going to be pretty exciting for the Cinema Scumbags. I think we've got some good things kind of.
We got some stuff coming up.
Yeah, you know, I touched on it last week, but the month of October, it's going to be popping for us.
Yeah, I don't know if you guys, I don't know if we've really officially announced it, but Scumbags 31 Days of Horror is a go.
We're going to make our best attempt. You know, we don't start shit and, you know, flake out. So it's going to happen.
It'll be there. We're going to have 31 videos horror related in the month of October. Look out.
Some guys announcing shit and then it never happens. We announce it. It happens. You're going to get a new video every day.
It's going to happen.
It's going to happen. That'll make up the month of October. And then, you know, right when you think it's going to let up for a little breather, that's when we're going to even fucking hit harder. Because November. November.
Shit's going to get lit.
Yep. November's going to be something else. We'll talk about that more, you know, as time gets closer. But there will be no shortage of content from us for the rest of the year. So you guys listen on iTunes. Don't know about the YouTube channel, youtube.com/cinemascumbags. It is essential that you come on over there. There's a lot of good stuff happening over there. Follow us on the social media platforms, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, @cinemascumbags. Stay in touch. Tweet us. Email us. Call into the scum line. The show is all about, you know, interaction with the listener. That's kind of what we strive off of, or, you know, thrive off of. I don't know what I'm talking about.
Just babbling.
So
thrive.
Thrive. Get in touch with us. Love hearing from you guys. Episode 64, right?
Yep.
Wrapping it up. Episode 64 in the books. Thank you guys for listening. And as always, go fuck yourselves.